Fill two internets with what Bob doesn't know about math.
But what he does know is no one plays a higher number of hits from the 80s, 90s, and whatever. Unable to count the countless songs he plays.
This is Bob.
The following is a special sports presentation from the EAB Sports Network.
It's time for Nettleton Raider Basketball on 101.3 Bob FM. Presented by NEA Baptist, Barton's Home Outlet, Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, Cavanaugh Auto Group, and First National Bank. Now, let's go to the NEA Baptist broadcast position for the First National Bank pregame show.
Yellow again, everybody. Welcome to another exciting edition of Nettleton Raider and Lady Raider basketball on 101.3 Bob FM and Nettleton Television. My name is Craig Miller, and I am pinch hitting for the voice of the Raiders, Jacob Linderman, just for a little while. Raider fans, good news. He is in the house. He's on his way up the bleachers right now. But he has been on a school trip today and knew that he would be rolling in just as the pregame show was started. So he hollered at the old TMC and asked if his old tag team partner could do the pregame show. And I am very glad to be doing it. I'll be handing it over to Jacob here in just a few minutes. But tonight it is Nettleton versus Paragould in Conference 5A East action. Our first game is the Lady Raiders versus the Lady Rams, which, as I've said before, is an obvious oxymoron, Lady Rams. But the Lady Raiders versus the Lady Rams is the first game. We're about 8 minutes away, 8.5 minutes away from tip-off. The guys will follow that game. The Lady Raiders are 19-7 overall. They're 5-5 in conference. Paragould is 0-22 overall, 0-10 in conference. You heard that right. Paragould, a girls basketball powerhouse, 0-22, 0-10 in conference. Now, that is a team that has been ravaged by injuries this year, and Mama said there'd be days like these, and boy, it's been a tough year for Paragould for sure. Nettleton and Paragould have tangled one time before. This is the second go around between these two teams. Nettleton won the previous contest by the score of 56-14. Nettleton is coming off a disappointing 57-52 loss at West Memphis last Friday night, and they're looking to get back to their usual winning ways tonight. With the win, the Lady Raiders would notch win number 20, and that is a great accomplishment for Coach Kevin Frisbee in his first year as the Lady Raiders head coach. This is a must-win for the Lady Raiders. They are 5-5 in conference, tied for fourth place. Now, let me remind you, in the 5A classification, there is no district tournament. There is no regional tournament. They play the season, and the top four teams at the end of the regular season qualify for state. They go directly to state. They do not pass go. They do not collect $200. Right now, the Lady Raiders are tied for fourth in conference. If they're going to qualify for state for the second straight year, they got to win. They got to win tonight. This is a must win for the Lady Raiders. I tell you what, we will take a one-minute break, and when we come back, we'll break down the standings of the 5A East. You've tuned in to the First National Bank pregame show, Nettleton versus Paragould, in just about 6.5 minutes. Back in 60 seconds with more of the First National Bank pregame show, Raider Basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
At First National Bank, our mortgage lending team knows what it takes to make a home and a superior home loan process. Simple, proven, and reliable service with competitive rates at a bank that already feels like home. Since 1889, that's been the First National Bank way, because for our people, this is home. Apply online at fnbank.net/mortgage. From our family to yours, welcome home. First National Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
NEA Baptist Women's Clinic is now accepting prenatal appointments. Ladies, if you're expecting, get the prenatal care you and baby need and treat yourself to an A-rated delivery experience when you combine the expert team of labor and delivery nurses with the prenatal care in our women's clinic. Call 936-8000 to schedule a prenatal appointment with one of our obstetricians at the NEA Baptist Women's Clinic. Meet the team and learn more at neabaptistclinic.org. NEA Baptist, we put the A in baby.
We welcome you back to Raider Gym, where tonight it is the Nettleton Lady Raiders in the first game of a Conference 5A East doubleheader taking on the Paragould Lady Rams. Our pregame coverage brought to you by First National Bank, where they put you first always. Let's take a look at the Conference 5A East standings as we're about 5 minutes away from tip-off here. In first place in the 5A East is the Greene County Tech Lady Eagles. They are 10-0, undefeated in conference. And, boy, Nettleton could have beat them both times, should have beat them both times. But like Coach Pat Hawk used to say, if ifs and buts were candy and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. They were able to get us twice, and they are number one in the conference at 10-0. Searcy is second in conference at 8-2. West Memphis is third, 6-4. Nettleton and Marion are tied for the fourth spot at 5-5, Nettleton and Marion. The rest of the conference, Batesville's in sixth place. They're 3-7. They're tied with Valley View, who's also 3-7. And Paragould, the Lady Rams, are 0-10. So Nettleton in fourth place, tied for fourth place, with four more games to go. They, of course, their competition, the team that we're watching right now, is Marion, because we're battling it out with Marion for that number four spot. So let's kind of compare the schedules going forward. Nettleton has four more games to go. Tonight they play Paragould here at home. Friday night they play Batesville here at home. That's going to be senior night, Raider Nation, so make sure that you're out here to say thank you to the class of 24 seniors. So Paragould, Batesville for the Lady Raiders. And then next week we play at Valley View on Tuesday, and then finish the regular season at Searcy in a big game next Friday night. Marion, the team that is tied with us for fourth place right now, they play Batesville tonight, Greene County Tech Friday. Then they finish up with Paragould and Valley View. So for those of you taking notes at home, we play Paragould, Batesville, Valley View, and Searcy. Marion plays Batesville, Greene County Tech, Paragould, and Valley View. We win, and I feel good about our chances of getting that four spot. I also feel good about our chances of getting that number four spot, because we do have the tiebreaker with the Lady Patriots, as we beat them by 19, and they only beat us by four. That's good news, but still, this is a must-win game, because it's must-win time for the Lady Raiders. Win, we will get in. Lose, and well, it'll be very tough to make state. So, in the words of Al Davis, just win, baby, just win. We'll take another 60-second break, and when we come back, we will introduce you to the starters, and then I'll hand things over to the voice of the Raiders, Jacob Linderman. So we'll be back in 60 minutes. We're about 2.5 minutes away from tip-off. Lady Raiders versus Lady Rams. Sure glad to have you here on NTV and the EAB Sports Network. Back in 60.
The team at Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine has been taking care of our local athletes for over 40 years. Now with two locations, including JOSM on Main and JOSM on Matthews inside St. Bernard's Health and Wellness Center. And now JOSM is offering a limited number of same-day appointments. Call 932-1820. Find them on Facebook and at JonesboroOrtho.com. Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, excelling in our field so you can excel on yours.
Play Against Sports wants to pay you money. Now that I have your attention, Played Against Sports in Jonesboro wants to buy your used sports equipment. You heard me right. If you have something that's either outgrown or no longer being used, bring it to Played Against Sports now. They're looking for youth and adult baseball and softball equipment, golf, weights and workout equipment, disc golf, you name it, Played Against Sports can turn it into cash for you. Go buy Played Against Sports at the corner of Highland and Caraway in Jonesboro.
You're listening to the Nettleton Raiders on Bob FM, 101.3 KIYS HD2 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, KIYS HD2, K23. 31 BB College City Jonesboro, KIYS HD4 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, and KIYS HD4 K267AS Piggott.
We're just about a minute away from tip, or a minute away from the national anthem anyway, and welcome you into the First National Bank pregame show. Our pregame coverage brought to you by First National Bank, where they put you first always. Let's talk about the starters for tonight, Paragould versus Nettleton. For Paragould, the probable starters are Emma Rolson and Anjaya Lurie, and forgive me for the mispronunciation, Hadley Luke, Haley Benson, and Kaylee Metz. As for the Lady Raiders, starters tonight are 6-foot senior Donna Douglas, 5'5 sophomore Takayla Marshall, 5'4 senior Carmen McShan, and 5'6 freshman Summer Morgan, 5'9 senior Mackenzie Williams. The juice rounds out the starting five. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to do the national anthem, and I do not ever want to talk over it. So we'll take a 2.5 minute break, and when we come back, we will have Jacob Linderman will bring all the action to you back in 2.5 minutes. Raider basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
cars.com.
Hey there, Northeast Arkansas. This is John Moore of Arkansas Superstore on Highway 49 in Brooklyn, here to tell you that we're flipping the script on car buying. Don't stand for bait and switch tactics.
That's holding.
We believe in transparency and trust. You deserve the car you want with a payment much lower than your rent. Arkansas Superstore is here to make sense of it all for you. Come over and find your dream ride. You're approved. When the banks say no, I say yes. Visit us today at 11580 Highway 49 North in Brooklyn or online at ArkansasSuperstore.com.
At Barton's, we see your commitment to making your project a success. From the pro up with the son that doesn't quit until it goes down to the DIYer who faces each challenge head on, our seasoned store partners support you every step of the way. Since 1885, Barton's has been the backbone of local communities for every type of project. From new construction to home remodel, our dedicated team is here to empower your project with local delivery options and a variety of complimentary project services, including expert kitchen planning. Visit your hometown team today and build it better with Barton's.
Go outside and play with Jonesboro Cycle and ATV. Jonesboro Cycle is your go-to for all your power sports needs, whether it be off-road, on-road, or on the wall. Check out their inventory of four-wheelers, side-by-sides, motorcycles, dirt bikes, cruisers, go-karts, scooters, personal watercrafts, boats, and even boat motors. Jonesboro Cycle is a 185,000 square foot motorsports mecca featuring all the name brands under one roof. Jonesboro Cycle and ATV on US Highway 63 North in Bono and JonesboroCycle.com.
FirstChoice.com.
Need top-notch farming and lawn gear? Visit First Choice Farm and Lawn, your Kubota dealer in Brooklyn. We get your need for reliable equipment. That's why we offer precision Kubota machinery for any task. From seasoned farmers to green-thumbed homeowners, we are working to keep you working. Find your Kubota match at First Choice Farm and Lawn on Highway 49 in Brooklyn. Achieve your goals faster with our Kubota inventory and top-notch service. Call 870-790-2301 or drop by today. Your trusted Kubota dealer, First Choice Farm and Lawn.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. Today, Raiders are playing the Lady Rams out of Paragould. 8 minutes set on the clock. The offensive starters and defensive starters being announced on the court. They're all the same people here in basketball. You got the Raiders getting announced. Get the Paragould lineup. I'm going to remind you of the starting lineups. For Paragould, they'll be starting number 2, Kaylee Metz. Number 3, Emma Reese Rolson. Goes by Reese Rolson. Number 20, Anijah Lurie. Number 24, Hadley Luke. And number 30, Haley Benson. And for the Lady Raiders, number 1, Carmen McShann. Number 11, Bunga Marshall. Number 13, Summer Morgan. Number 33, The Juice McKenzie Williams. And rounding it out, number 44, D1 Donna Douglas. It's the Raiders starting 5. They are the head nod almost every game. I don't think they haven't started a single game for the Lady Raiders. Looks like I called out a starter incorrectly. Paragould's be starting number 33, Madison Harrell. Looks like instead of number 2, Kaylee Metz. Lady Raiders jumping D1 Nada, and the Rams jumping Anijah Lurie. Raiders in their home white uniforms with the gold lettering, gold down the side. Paragould in the road blues. Donna tips it backwards. Reese Rolson comes away with it. Rolson brings it up the court. 7:50 on the clock as she crosses the timeline. Goes to the left side on the left wing. Crosses over a few times. Goes inside to number 24, Luke. They kick out to Benson. Benson's shot. I believe it's blocked but tipped out of bounds by number 20, Anijah Lurie. Referees conversing it. They're going to change the call. Thought Lurie might have had a hand on it as it went out of bounds. However, they're going to give it to Paragould. Number 24, Hadley Luke set to inbound. Luke floats one back to Reese Rolson. They go back to Luke on the left wing. Luke inside to Benson. Benson turn around, shot up. Shot is good. Paragould scores first. 0-2 is the score. Paragould has the advantage. Carmen Shan kicks down to D1 Donna. Donna power dribble layup up. No good. However, she is fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot 2. Foul's going to be charged, I believe, against number 30. That's Benson, Haley Benson. That's her first personal team foul, number 1. At the line, shooting 2 is Donna Douglas. Douglas makes her first one. Raiders cut down the lead to 1. 1-2 is the score. Make it 2-2 after the Donna Douglas second free throw. We're all tied up here at Raider Gym. 7:20 remaining here in the first quarter. Number 3, Rolson, bringing the ball down the court. She's going to go right this time. Gets a screen. Going to drive. Loses the grip on it. Pulls it back out. Goes inside to Lurie. However, intercepted by McShann. McShann's going to be fouled, and the foul's going to be called against number 20, Anijah Lurie. That's Lurie's first personal team foul, number 2. 7:06 remaining here in the first quarter at Raider Gym. We're in the NEA Baptist broadcast position here at Raider Gym. NEA Baptist Healthcare for the next century. Number 13, Zimmer Morgan, brings the ball up the court. Goes left to number 11, Bunga Marshall. Marshall to D1 Donna. Donna inside to the Juice. Turnaround layup is good. Count it. Makes it 4-2. 6:50 remaining here in the first quarter. Number 3, Rolson, bringing the ball down the court. Rolson going to in and out move. Make a couple of shifty dribbles. Goes to the left wing. Kicks the Hadley Luke. Luke drives the right side, pulls up from about 15, sinks it, makes it 4-4. 6:30 remaining here in the first quarter. McShann down to Bunga Marshall in the corner. She's going to drive the baseline layup up and under. Is good. Makes it 6-4. Raiders back up by 2. 6:20 remaining here in the first quarter. Number 3, Rolson with the ball. Rolson at the volleyball line. She's going to go to the right wing, picked up by Marshall.
They kicked at number 24, Luke. Luke, long range three, almost fell, rims out last second. Rebound goes to Summer Morgan. Morgan going coast to coast like butter toast, and little dog's name Rover makes the layup, makes it 8-4. What a down the court move from Summer Morgan. Number three, Rolson bringing the ball down the court. 5:50 remaining here in the first quarter. Rolson goes right side with it, pulls it out, sets up a little high of the wing. Now coming back the other way, stands at the volleyball line, top of the key. She's going to drive the right side, kick out to number 33, Harrell. Harrell, one dribble, pulls up from the elbow, air balls. Rebound goes to Donna Douglas. Douglas out to Summer Morgan. Morgan bringing it down the court, kicks to Bunga Marshall. Marshall, corner three, just a little strong. Rebound, Summer Morgan. Morgan in the corner, has a count against her. She kicks to Donna Douglas. Douglas to McSham. McSham from the elbow. No good. Rebound to Anaja Lurie. Rebound to Paragold. 5:08 remaining here in the first quarter. 8-4 is the score. Reese Rolson with the ball. Rolson crosses over a couple of times. She goes left this time. Stands at the left wing, letting the play develop. 18 seconds on the shot clock. She goes over to Benson. Benson guarded by the juice. Steps out. Hands around the top of the key. Goes back to Rolson. 8 seconds now on the shot clock. Rolson crosses over a few times. Goes left. Now goes to Harrell. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Harrell's shot is blocked by Summer Morgan. Here comes Raiders. Morgan driving down the court. She's going to kick out to Bunga Marshall in the corner. Corner three from Marshall. Just a little strong again. That one did not fall. Raiders with the rebound. However, ball will go out of bounds. Be last touched by the Lady Raiders. Into the ball game for the Lady Rams is going to be number one, Madison Farmer, a 5'6 sophomore. They inbound into Farmer. Farmer goes back to Rolson. Rolson trying to beat the press by herself. Finally gets some help. Kicks over to Luke. Luke going to step out of bounds to be a Lady Raider ball. Donna Douglas did a good job forcing the turnover there. Stood on the sideline, stood tall, and used her body to push her out of bounds. Good job, Donna Douglas, creating the defensive stop right there. 4:15 remaining here in the first quarter. 8-4 is the score. Raiders up by four. They inbound in. They get it down low to D1 Donna. We're going to have a foul on the floor. Donna missed her shot. It would be an off-the-ball foul, I believe, on the rebound. All right, called against number 24, Hadley Luke. Be her first personal team foul, number three. 4:07 remaining here in the first. Bunga Marshall inbounds into McShan. McShan picked up by Rolson. We're going to have a foul against Rolson. Be her first personal team foul, number four. 4:05 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders really close to that bonus. The next foul, they'll be at the line shooting two. Number 11, Bunga Marshall is set to inbound. Marshall, the sophomore for the Raider team, has a heavy impact for the Lady Raiders. Number one, McShan receives the inbound. She's going to go right side with it, go to Summer Morgan on the right wing. Morgan goes inside to the juice off a pick and cut. Juice makes her layup, makes it 10-4. Raiders up by six. 3:50 remaining here in the first quarter. Farmer kicks back to Rolson. They go right back to Farmer. Farmer on right wing goes down low to Lurie. Tipped out of bounds. It'll be last touch by Nigel Lurie. It's going to be Raider ball. 3:43 remaining here in the first quarter. Lady Raiders with the early lead up by six here in the first. Summer Morgan bringing the ball down the court. 3:36 remaining here in the game. Goes to the volleyball line. She gets a screen. Goes right side with it. She's going to drive the rack. Wide open lane. Sinks the layup. Good hustle play by Summer Morgan. 12-4 Raiders up by eight. They get it down to Benson. Benson to Lurie. Lurie layup off the glass. Falls. Makes it 12-6. 3:15 remaining here in the first quarter. Number one, Carmen Shan bringing it down the court. Tries to hit a cutting Summer Morgan. However, pass tipped out of bounds by Madison Farmer. It's going to be Lady Raider ball under their own goal. 3:10 remaining here in the first quarter. 12-6 is the score. Raiders up by six. Bunga Marshall inbounds in. Number one, Carmen Shan. McShan's three-point shot, no good. Out of bounds, last touch by the Rams. Be Raider ball. 3:05 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders with the ball. Set to inbound. It's going to be number one, McShan, this time. Shan inbounding off her shot. She gets it into Douglas. Douglas spin around. Shot is good. Raiders back up by eight. 14-6 is the score. 2:58 remaining here in the first quarter. Rolston inbounds into Farmer. Farmer skips it over to Luke. Luke drives the baseline, kicks back to Rolston. Rolston to Farmer in the middle of the court. They beat the press. They kick down to Lurie. Lurie layup is good. Makes it 14-8. 2:40 remaining here in the first quarter. 14-8 is the score. Raiders up by 6. Summer Morgan bringing the ball down the court. She's got two screens. Uses the one on the left side. Shot fakes, kicks to the juice. The juice skips it down to Bunga Marshall in the left corner. They kick to cutting Summer Morgan. Morgan could not gain possession. Throws it away. Number one, Farmer with the ball. Farmer goes over number three, Rolson. Rolson at the volleyball line. Sending up the offense, gets the screen, goes right. Has a few cutters down low, waiting for the play to develop. She kicks to Farmer, top of the key. Farmer gets the pocket pick. Bunga Marshall is going to take it the other way. Marshall, wide open, fast break, sinks the layup. I thought she could have dunked it. However, just lays it in with ease. 16-8 is the score. We're going to have a timeout on the floor. I believe it's going to be a timeout Paragold. We have a 30-second timeout. We'll take it with a 1:53 remaining here in the first. 16-8 is the score. Raiders up by it. Be back in 30 on the EAB Sports Network.
Evolve Bank and Trust offers a variety of residential and consumer loans, specializing in unique products and services while providing individualized customer service designed to fit your needs. Whether you're buying your first home, a new car, or building your dream home, Evolve Bank and Trust has the personal loan products you need to realize your dreams today. Call Evolve Bank and Trust at 870-933-2480. Stop in to see them at 111 East Huntington Suite A or visit them online at getevolve.com. Evolve Bank and Trust, making banking personal again. Evolve Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Raider basketball here on the EAB Sports Network and Nettleton TV. However you're joining us, we're glad you're joining us. Jacob Linderman bringing you the action tonight. Shout out to Craig Miller opening us up with our pregame show. Got back from Little Rock on a east trip. Paragold with the ball. Reese Rawson with it. She's picked up by Jessica Collins. Raiders had a couple of sub in. Collins goes to Lurie. Lurie picked up by Butler. They get it down to number 24, Hadley Luke. Luke back to Rolson. Rolson to Lurie. Lurie guarded by Aubriana Butler. They get it to Luke. Luke throws a ball out of bounds. I'd say there's a foul on the floor. Foul against number 11, Bunga Marshall. Her first personal team foul, number one. Raiders doing a very good job of staying out of foul trouble so far in this game. They kick inbounds to Reese Rolson. Rolson goes back down to Luke. Luke backing down the juice. Floats a pass to number five, Alexa Jackson. They get it back to Rolson. Rolson pulls up from about the free throw line and one. What a interesting shot. Got it to fall. A little bit of a floater and bounced off the back iron of the rim and goes in. Makes it 16-10. 1:18 remaining here in the first quarter. Rolson's and one is good. Gets all three of her points. 16-12, it says. I believe it should be 11. Number two, Jessica Collins with the ball. Now it switched to 11. Collins to Butler. Butler to the juice. Juice wide open, top of the key. Pull up three. No good. Rebound to Paragold to Lurie. Lurie to Rolson. Rolson's going to dribble it up the court for the Lady Rams. Rolson crosses the timeline. Goes over right. Kicks over to number two, Madison Farmer. Farmer with the ball. Farmer. Excuse me, that's Metz. Number two, Kaylee Metz. Excuse me to the Metz family. Metz over to Rolson. Rolson, 15 seconds on the shot clock, 42 seconds on the game clock. They're going to say she's fouled. And fouls me charged, I believe, against Kiara Brown. Kiki Brown. They're going to call against number two, Jessica Collins. I assumed I saw two. I thought he was going to throw a five as well. That meant Kiki. However, number two, Jessica Collins, picks up the call. Her first personal, second personal team foul, number three. Number three, Rolson with the ball. Rolson over to Metz. Metz going to drive right side, kicks to Rolson in the right corner. Rolson into Lurie. Lurie pulls up, sinks her shot, makes it 16-13. Raiders still up by three. 24 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Number two, Collins with the ball. Collins goes right, kicks to Butler. Butler is going to go left, kicks to Marshall. Marshall, top of the key, back to Collins' right wing. She's going to dribble inside, hit a backdoor cutting Aubrey Butler. Butler sinks the layup with 6 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Rolson playing a little hurry up, gets it down the court. and doesn't get a shot off in time at the end of the first quarter. We're going to end it. Raiders up by 5. 18-13 is the score. Raiders up by 5. We take a 60-second break. We can come back right after the second quarter. Be back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
For over a decade, the Arkansas Children's Hospital Jonesboro Clinic has served pediatric patients with specialty health care needs ranging from hearing loss to heart disease. Their doctors, nurses, and pediatric specialists, combined with state-of-the-art telemedicine options, means patients get the nationally ranked care Arkansas Children's Hospital is known for without driving to Little Rock. Bringing care close to your home to give kids more time to be kids is the Arkansas Children's commitment. Visit archildrens.org/NEA.
Whether you're replacing an old appliance or remodeling your whole kitchen, the appliances you need are right around the corner with GE Appliances at Tucker's Appliance Superstore in Jonesboro. Shop timeless designs and time-saving features on the appliances that are built to last in the busiest homes. Visit Tucker's Appliance today and upgrade your home your way with GE Appliances and your local experts. Shop Tucker's Appliance today and save.
Tucker's Appliance.
Lady Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. We're glad you're joining us here on this Tuesday afternoon. Lady Raiders with the ball. Summer Morgan, top of the key, goes to D1 Donna. Donna Douglas kicks back to Morgan on a backdoor cut. Good play by the Raiders, creating that ball, move it. Gets it to 20-13. Raiders back up by 7. Number 3, Rolson with the ball. Rolson crosses the timeline. Going to go over number 30. That's Benson. Benson with the ball. Benson at the left part of the wing. She goes to Lurie. She's on the right side now. A little high at the top of the key. Raiders going to force a jump ball. Lurie is just holding it out there. And Simon Morgan said, I'll touch it. And that got a jump ball for the Raiders. Into the ball game for Paragon number 33, Madison Harrell. Coming in for number 2, Kaylee Metz. Paragon sets up a stack play. They inbound to Rolson. Rolson with the ball, setting up the Paragold offense. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Rolson drives right, kicks to Hadley Luke. Luke drives left, rolls around, spin move, kicks back to Harrell. Harrell, 2 seconds on the shot clock. They got to get a shot off, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Be Lady Raider ball. 7-10 remaining here in the second quarter. 20-13 is the score. Raiders up by 7. Summer Morgan inbounds the ball. She inbounds in to Aubrey Butler. Butler goes back to Morgan. Morgan crosses the timeline, goes to the top of key, kicks to Jessica Cullens. Cullens, spin move, crossover, kicks to number 25, Kiki Brown. Brown to D1 Donna down low. Donna to Aubrey Butler. Butler, one dribble pull up in the corner, sinks it, makes it 23-13. Raiders up by 10. Number 3, Rolson bringing it down the court. Going to walk it down the court. About 30 seconds on the shot clock as she passes the timeline. Rolson with the ball. Rolson kicks over to number 33, Madison Harrell. Harrell, a couple of jab steps. Kicks over to Lurie. Lurie with the ball. Makes a couple of jab steps. Kicks down low. Pass intercepted by the Raiders. Jessica Cullen on the takeaway. She's going to the rack. Euro. 1-2. Sinks her layup. Makes it 25-13 with 6:15 remaining here in the second. Hey, Raiders getting hot here in the second quarter. Paragold with the ball. Number 3, Rolson with it. Rolson, a couple of crossovers. Doesn't have a count on her. However, the shot clock is still winding down. She fakes right, goes left, now goes back right, kicks to Harrell. Harrell on the right wing. She dribbles back left side. Picks up her dribble, kicks to number 24, Hadley Luke. Luke, left side, 6 seconds on the shot clock. Gets fouled, be a bell out call as the shot clock was about 4 seconds away from a violation. Foul charging is number 25, Kiki Brown, her first personal team foul, number 1. 5:43 remaining here in the second quarter. Number 24, Hadley Luke, is set to inbound. Paragold wraps around a couple of stacks. They kick to Rolson. Rolson in the corner left side. Dribbles to the top of the key, sets up the offense. Hesitation move from Rolson. She goes over to Harrell. Harrell with it right side. She's going to drive left, pick up her dribble, a fadeaway. Makes it 25-15. Raiders up by 10. 5:20 remaining here in the second quarter. Summer Morgan bringing the ball down the court, slowly walking it up for the offense. Now she kicks it in third gear. misses her layup on her drive. Paragold with the rebound. Reese Rolson with it. Rolson right side. She's going to make a couple moves. Kicks to Harrell top of the key. Harrell back to Rolson right wing. Rolson going to drive left, drive to the rack. Pull up floater off the glass. No good. Rebound. Aubrey Butler. Butler playing a little bit of a slowdown game. Setting up the Lady Raider offense. She's now going to drive right. Kicks to Collins. Collins on the wing. Goes inside to D1Donna. They go right back to Jessica Collins. Collins for three. No good. Rebound. Number 33, Harrell. However, Summer Morgan does a good job of deflecting it. However, on her save, she throws it away. Number 24, Luke with it. Luke drives down into the corner. Kicks out. Pass intercepted, however. Aubriana Bower. She has a fast break. Wide open lane. Butler gets it blocked. They're going to say it went off her knee. The Lady Ram ball. Raiders bringing in another big group of sub, bringing in three players, one fresh player, number 22, Taylor Thomas, coming into the game. Number one, Carmen Shan. Number 33, the Juice back in it. They're coming in for Collins, Morgan, and Brown. Number 24, Luke bringing it down the court. Hadley Luke stops at the volleyball line, moves it down to the top of key, kicks to number one, Farmer, left side. Farmer going to drive right with it. Goes to Harrell. Harrell could not catch it. Aubrey Butler takes it away. Butler picking up the gear, playing a little bit faster. Kicks down to the Juice. The Juice, couple of dribbles, layup, no good. Rebound goes to the Juice. The Juice makes the second one, makes it 27-15. Raiders back up by 12. 3:45 remaining here in the second quarter. Number 24, Luke with the ball. Luke bringing it down the court on a slow jog. Jogs it all the way down to the top of the Raider end. Gets it over to Farmer, left side. Farmer, a fadeaway, no good. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by number five, Alexa Jackson of Paragould. 3:20 remaining here in the second quarter. Make sure you do stick around for the Kavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Halftime is presented by the Kavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Kavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at KavanaughCars.com. Number five, Aubrey Butler with it. Butler, top of the key, goes to Carmen McShann. McShann. Senior goes over to Taylor Thomas. Thomas with the ball. Back to Butler. Butler to McShann. Left corner. Pull up three. No good. Rebound to Thomas. She goes to the Juice on a trick pass. Juice gets it and one. Count the basket. She'll go to the line to shoot the hoop and the harm. 3:07 remaining here in the second quarter. 29-15. Raiders up by 14. Foul charge number five, Alexa Jackson. Her first personal first team foul. Juice makes her first and only one at the line. Makes it 30-15. Raiders up by 15 here at Raider Gym. Paragold bringing in a couple of subs. Bringing back in number three, Reese Rolson. Number 23, Elijah Lurie. Number three, Rolson bringing it down the court. Going to jog it across the timeline here at Raider Gym. Hesitation move at the volleyball line. She's going to go left with it. Kicks the Farmer. Farmer. Left side, left wing, goes around the corner. He can be fouled. Foul charge against number five, Aubrey Butler. That's, I believe, her first personal. Team foul number two. Number 30, Benson is set to inbound. She goes to Farmer. Farmer gonna go to the volleyball line at the top of the key. She's gonna drive right side with it. Goes to Elijah Lurie. Lurie to number three. Rolson. Rolson top of the key. He's going to drive right side with it. Kicks to Benson at the left elbow. First shot up. Shot no good. Rebound to the Juice. The Juice down to number one McShann to D1 Donna. Donna under the rim. Lays it in with finesse. Makes it 32-15. Number three, Rolson bringing it down the court for the Lady Rams. Raiders up by 17 here at Raider Gym. They get it over to number one, Farmer. Farmer. Pulls it back out, setting up the offense. 20 seconds on the shot clock. She drives left, now coming back the right side. She gets a pass off to Benson. Benson trying to back down Douglas, picks up her dribble, decides not to, kicks out to Farmer. Farmer, top of the key, 7 seconds on the shot clock. They go to Rolson. Rolson, pull up three. Desperation heave to beat the shot clock. No good. Rebound Taylor Thomas. Thomas is going to be fouled. It'll be fouled on the floor. He's going to be against number five, Alexa Jackson, picks up her second personal team foul, number two. 1:49 remaining here in the second quarter. 80 Raiders up by 17. 1:45 remaining here in the second quarter. Number one, McShann, bringing it down the court for the Lady Raiders. Kind of walking across the timeline. Picks up a jog at the volleyball line. Goes over Taylor Thomas. Thomas down to Kaylee Franklin. Franklin left-hand layup, no good. And Franklin's going to pick up her first foul. Foul against number 35, Kaylee Franklin. Her first personal team foul, number three. 1:31 remaining here in the second quarter. 32-15 is the score. Raiders up by 17. Number one, Farmer back to Rolson. Rolson bringing it down the court for the Lady Rams. She's going to jog it across the timeline. She goes left side with it. Makes a couple of crossover. Gets a screen. Doesn't use the screen. Goes the opposite way. Sinks a layup. Right hand, left side. Number one, McShann brings it down the court on the right wing. Setting up the offense. Now moving over to the top of the key. McShann thought about passing it. Now finally does. Kicks to Bunga Marshall. Marshall goes to Taylor Thomas. Thomas right wing. He's going to create separation. Drive to the rack, and she gets fouled. Comes down quickly. However, she's up quickly. That's always a good sign. Foul against number five, Alexa Jackson. Her third personal team foul, number three. 32-17 is the score. Raiders up by 15. Number one, McShann is set to inbound. Back into the ballgame is Elijah Lurie for Paragould. They have Elijah and Anijah. Both of them are out on the court. Number 33, the juice off the inbound pull-up three. Does not make it. Kicks Raiders with the rebound. They kick out to Thomas. Thomas to McShann. McShann pull-up long range two. That one no good. Rebound in the air. A fight for it. Reese Rolson on the takeaway. Rolson. Jeez, fast break all the way down the court. Floater up. Floater is good. Makes it 32-19. McShann, long range pass to number 33, the Juice. Tipped away, tipped out of bounds. Going to be a Raider ball. 27.6 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. 32-19 is the score. Raiders up by 13. Number 11, Bunga Marshall with the ball. Marshall inbounds into Franklin. Franklin left-hand layup is good. Makes it 34-19. Raiders back up by 15. Rolson jogging it down the court. Going to stop at the volleyball line. Now goes down to the left side, the left wing area. He's going to hesitate, go right. Gets the ball tipped away. They get it down to Carmen McShann. McShann on the fast break. 5 seconds on the clock. Makes her layup. Makes it 36-19. That's going to end regulation here in the second quarter. They're going to call an in and out call on that sideline. However, it's no need to. The buzzer expired. That's the end of the first half. Hey, make sure you do stick around for our Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Halftime is presented by the Cavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Cavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. We're going to take a 3-minute break. When we come back, we're going to have the Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Be back in 3 minutes on the EAB Sports Network.
Every Cavanaugh dealership. Cavanaugh has a great selection of late model, low mileage, certified pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. And most are still under factory warranty. We have every make and every model, so you're sure to find the vehicle you want. And when you buy at Cavanaugh, every new and used purchase comes with 1 year of free maintenance. Plus, we buy cars.
Bring a vehicle?
Get a check. Come see us today at one of our dealerships or go to CavanaughCars.com.
This is Bob Moore with Moore Air Conditioning. Is your HVAC system ready for fall and winter? Find out today with the Moore Super Checkup. Prevent unexpected breakdowns while extending the life of your system. Whether you need a heating or cooling inspection, we cover it all for just $55 for 55 years serving you. Call Moore Air Conditioning today, 870-260-7030, or visit us at moreac.com. Don't settle for less.
You deserve more. Don't settle for less.
Nettleton High School Athletics is brought to you by Gateway Tire and Service Center and Toyo Tires. Where there's always one thing you can count on, we go the distance for you. Before you hit the road for a trip across country or across town, drop by Gateway Tire and Service Center and check out the great deals on Toyo Tires. Whether it's tires or auto repair, you can always count on one thing. At Gateway Tire and Toyo Tires, we go the distance for you. At Gateway Tire in Jonesboro, we go the distance for you.
It's a mix and match special now at all Northeast Arkansas Domino's Pizza locations. Choose any two for $6.99 each for carryout or delivery. How about a medium two-topping pizza, oven-baked sandwich, pasta and a tin, loaded tots, Domino's stuffed cheesy bread, bread twists, marble brownies, and so much more. Switch it up for lunch or dinner for the whole gang. The mix and match special with any two for only $6.99 each for carryout or delivery. Only at your Northeast Arkansas area Domino's Pizza locations.
Mom, I can't get my homework to upload.
Dad, my video game is froze again.
Babe, is our internet down again? I'm missing the big game.
Honey, I'm trying to make this online payment, but it just keeps buffering.
Get your life up to speed with high-speed internet from Empower Broadband. Empower's reliable service brings high-speed internet to even the most remote areas of Northeast Arkansas. With Empower Broadband, you can stream your favorite movies, video chat with loved ones, work from home without interruptions, and so much more. Empower Broadband. Life up to speed. For more info, visit empowerbroadband.com.
Having trouble getting the trailer you need? Silver Line Trailers, the largest trailer retailer in the USA, has the perfect solution for you. Guaranteed approval. No credit check required. Get the quality trailer you need at a price you can afford. With over 3,500 trailers available and more coming in daily, we'll find the perfect trailer for you. And at Silver Line, we're always looking to hire good people. Visit our website, silverlinetrailer.com, for a location near you. You can stop by our Jonesboro location today at 3711 Stadium Boulevard or call 870-203-0000. Silver Line Trailers, your trusted trailer retailer.
Hello, folks. I'd like to welcome you in to the Cavanaugh Auto Group Halftime Show here at Raider Gym. Halftime is presented by the Cavanaugh Auto Group. You can check out Cavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. If you're watching on the broadcast, you're seeing the Little Lady Raider cheerleaders. There's a bunch of them out on the floor. I believe we had a cheerleading camp. They're doing a little dancing performance right now if you're watching on the live stream. We're going to go ahead and break down the scoring quarter by quarter. Raiders have the advantage right now, 36 to 19 is the score. Raiders scored 18 in each quarter. Paragould scored 13 in the first quarter and 6 in the second. For the first quarter, Lady Raiders had four of their scorers with 4 points. And Aubrey Butler had two. Marshall, Morgan, Williams, and Douglas all had 4 points. All scored primarily layup-wise. Donna Douglas had two free throws that she made. In the second quarter, the Raiders spread it out a little bit more evenly. The Juice was the leading scorer. She had five. Butler with three. Then McShann had two. Morgan with two. Douglas with two. Jessica Collins and Kaylee Franklin all had 2 points for the Lady Raiders. For the Paragould Rams, their first quarter leading scorer was number 20, Anaja Lurie. She had 6 points. Reese Rolson had three. Hadley Luke and Haley Benson joined them with 2 points apiece. In the second quarter, Reese Rolson had four, and then Madison Harrell had 2 points. That makes up all of Paragould's points, 13 in the first, 6 in the second. Raiders had 18 apiece in each of them. Lady Raiders are led by number 33, Mackenzie Williams. She has 9 total points. She scored 4 in the first, 5 in the second. Right behind her is number 13, Summer Morgan. Morgan had 6. Marshall had 4. Butler has 5. McShann with 2. Collins and Franklin also with their 2. Leading scorer for the Paragould Rams is Reese Rolson. Rolson has 7. Lurie with 6. And then Luke, Benson, and Harrell all have 2 for the Lady Rams. We're about 7 minutes away from third quarter action here at Raider Gym. You're joining us for our Cavanaugh Auto Group Halftime Show. Halftime is always presented by the Cavanaugh Auto Group. You can check out Cavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. Glad you're joining us here tonight. Make sure you do stick around for the boys' game to follow. As soon as this game's over, we'll flip our post-game show to the pre-game show of the boys' game. The boys, forerunners of the 5A East right now, have an outstanding, I believe, 9-1 record after taking West Memphis and beating them at West Memphis. Very impressive game. Beating West Memphis is always tough. Beating West Memphis at home is tougher. The Lady Raiders lost to West Memphis, had a very slow start, I believe they lost by 7 points at West Memphis. However, right now, they're looking very strong against this Paragould Ram team. Lady Raiders and Ram squared off earlier this season, actually on January, I believe, 30th. They snowed game, canceled them out. The reason they weren't on January 16th as scheduled, harsh weather came through the east parts of Jonesboro, Arkansas. It kind of snowed out all the 5A East games. Every game got moved to the same day. We all played our respective opponents. I believe that of you played West Memphis that night. Batesville, I think, took on Marion. I'm not sure if that's correct. GCT with Searcy. I think that is right. I'm not for sure. I'll double check after the halftime show. Make sure I tell you all the wrong stats. I don't tell you all the wrong stats because that would be the game of the night again. Right now, the Raiders are on the court warming up. Both girls and boys are out there about 5 minutes away. We're going to take a quick 3 minute break. When we come back, we're going to have the end of the Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Be back in 3 minutes on the EAB Sports Network.
What started with our grandfather and continues in its fourth generation today, Glen Sane's history of quality sales, service, and strong personal relationships that have kept our customers and their families coming back for over 69 years.
From my grandpa to my dad to us, service after the sale is a big deal. Whether you're looking to buy a GMC, Chevrolet, Buick, or Ford, we look forward to serving you and your family for years to come.
NEA Baptist Women's Clinic is now accepting prenatal appointments. Ladies, if you're expecting, get the prenatal care you and baby need and treat yourself to an A-rated delivery experience when you combine the expert team of labor and delivery nurses with the prenatal care in our women's clinic. Call 936-8000 to schedule a prenatal appointment with one of our obstetricians at the NEA Baptist Women's Clinic. Meet the team and learn more at neabaptistclinic.org. NEA Baptist, we put the A in baby.
The team at Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine has been taking care of our local athletes for over 40 years. Now with two locations, including JOSM on Main and JOSM on Matthews inside St. Bernard's Health and Wellness Center. And now JOSM is offering a limited number of same-day appointments. Call 932-1820. Find them on Facebook and at JonesboroOrtho.com. Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, excelling in our field so you can excel on yours.
When this is the sound of a waterfall in nature, there's no cause for concern. But when it's the sound of water gushing through your living room ceiling because a pipe burst inside the wall, there's reason to panic, unless you pick up the phone and call 1-800-SERV-PRO. Only the cleanup and restoration specialists at ServPro can help make fire and water damage like it never even happened. So make the call to 1-800-SERV-PRO at the first sign of water damage. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
Or call me, David Ellison, at 870-897-7888 or 870-934-0501 for your next fire or water cleanup.
Enjoy no hassles and no hidden fees when you sign up for a free checking account at First Community Bank. Our free checking account comes with the great features you've come to enjoy and expect, such as bill pay, no minimum balance, no monthly service charge, and no paper statement fees. You can also monitor your checking account through our online banking. Enjoy convenient, worry-free checking and friendly, helpful service from First Community Bank, where community comes first. Member FDIC. Minimum $50 to open account. Checking accounts without activity may be charged dormant account fees.
Get huge savings now at every Cavanaugh dealership. Cavanaugh has a great selection of late model, low mileage, certified pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. And most are still under factory warranty. We have every make and every model, so you're sure to find the vehicle you want. And when you buy at Cavanaugh, every new and used purchase comes with 1 year of free maintenance. Plus, we buy cars.
Bring a vehicle?
Get a check. Come see us today at one of our dealerships or go to CavanaughCars.com.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. About a minute 40 away from the start of the third. The Raiders boys team still out on the court warming up. Farrell just now making it to the court. Raiders doing a little bit of a dunk contest, what it looks like. They're clearing the court. Q Thompson have the last attempt. He grabs rim, doesn't throw it down. Good attempt from Q Thompson. We're about a minute away from the start of the third quarter. Talk about games around the 5A East tonight. Right now, Greene County Tech and Marion squaring off at Marion. Batesville plays Searcy. Lady Raiders are here playing Paragould. The final game is West Memphis and Valley View at Valley View. Raiders play Valley View next Tuesday. It'll be a big game. Valley View is tied for second place right now with the Marion Patriots. Raiders in the prominent 1 seed. 9-1 is the grand standing for the Raider boys team. Girls are in the battle for third place. We're about 38 seconds away from the start of the third quarter. Both teams are in their finalizing huddle, getting everything squared away here at Raider Gym. We're in the NEA Baptist broadcast position. NEA Baptist Healthcare for the next century. 38-19 is the score going into the third quarter. Lady Raiders with the advantage going into it. 36-19. Excuse me, I had some M&Ms in my mouth before I went on air, and then I heard the music. It was a little bit of catastrophic. However, everything's all squared away. We're ready for play here at Raider Gym. Raiders scored 18 apiece in each quarter so far. They held Paragould to 6 in the last one. Lady Raiders going with their original starting five. Looks like Paragould is doing the same. They're bringing out Rolson, Lurie, Luke, Benson, and Harrell. Raiders bringing out McShann, Marshall, Morgan, Williams, and D1 Donna Douglas. Lady Raiders in a weird split. They have a D1 Donna starting out in the corner. Might be a corner three from Donna Douglas. But one, Carmen Shan is set up left side. She's going to drive it to Donna Douglas' side. They go into the juice. Juice not tall enough to reach it. Intercepted by the Paragould Rams. Number three, Reese Rolson with it. Off of the Harrell interception. Rolson's going to drive right side with it. Has the screen. Uses the screen. Goes to Luke. Luke at the elbow of the three-point line. Kicks to number three. That's Rolson. Rolson inside to number 30, Benson. Benson goes around Douglas, misses her layup. Rebound tipped away, goes to Harrell. Harrell over number 24. That's Hadley Luke. Luke with it, pulls up, no good. Off the front iron, rebound goes to number 44, D1 Donna. Donna Douglas, she goes to number one, Carmen McShann. Lady Raiders with the ball. McShann, top of the key, goes to number 11, Bunga Marshall. Marshall, she's going to drive left side, crosses over, now driving right, kicks to Summer Morgan. Morgan pull up three on the right wing, splashes it, makes it 39-19. Raiders up by 20. Reese Rolson bringing the ball down the court for the Lady Raiders. Rolson dribbles across the timeline. She's going to go left this time. Bunga Marshall swishes over. They get it to number 33, Harrell. Harrell to Benson. Benson back to Harrell. Harrell top of the key. Pull up three. Splashes it. Makes it 39-22. Raiders lead cut down to 17. They get it over to Bunga Marshall. Marshall to Morgan. Morgan inside to D1 Donna. Donna turn around. Sinks her layup. Makes it 41-22. Number three, Rolson's going to bring the ball down the court. She's going to set it up at the top of the key. She's going to go right side with it. Stands on the right wing. Goes to number 24. That's Luke. Hadley Luke going. She goes all the way to the left corner with it. Throws the ball into Lurie. Let's go out of bounds. Try to get it into Nyjah Lurie. Bunga Marshall did a good job of tipping it away, tipping it out of bounds. 6:05 remaining here in the third quarter. Number three, Rolson with the ball. Reese Rolson goes inside to Benson. Excuse me, that's Luke. Luke to Harrell. Harrell top of the key. Crosses over. Picks up her dribble. Now they go to Benson. Benson driving to the rack. They're going to call a pushing foul to be on the floor. Foul against number 44, Donna Douglas. Boy, that's Douglas's first personal team foul, number one. Donna is one of those athletes who came a long way in basketball. See her improve almost every game. 5:52 remaining here in the third quarter. Number 30, Benson. Over to Harrell. Harrell right side. Harrell skips it over to number three, Rolson. Rolson pulls up floater off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound to the Lady Raiders. Number one, McShann bringing the ball up the court. McShann crosses the timeline. She kicks over to number 13, Summer Morgan. Morgan jab steps. Gets it down to number 33, Mackenzie Williams. Williams tried to save it, stepped on the out-of-bounds marker via Lady Ramball. 5:32 remaining here in the third quarter. 41-22 is the score. joining us here in our NEA Baptist broadcast edition, NEA Baptist Healthcare for the Next Century. Wilson gets a screen, crosses over, goes to the right wing. Wilson dribbling around, picks up her dribble, goes number 33, Harrell. Harrell with the ball. Harrell kicks to Hadley Luke. They go inside to Benson. Benson, a couple of spin moves. She's going to be fouled. Foul against Donna Douglas, her second personal, team foul number two. 5:11 remaining here in the third quarter. 41-22 is the score. Raiders up by 19. Benson's first shot at the line to cut the lead. Makes it 41-23. Raider lead cut down to 18. Number 30, Benson at the line. Second shot up. Second shot is good. Cuts it back down to 17. 5:10 remaining here in the third quarter, 41-24. Number 13, Summer Morgan over to number one, Carmen McShan. McShan, she's going to go left side with it. Stands right around the volleyball line. She's going to drive left, kicks over to Summer Morgan. Morgan crosses over. She kicks out to Bunga Marshall. Marshall wide open, 3-8, top of the key. No good. Rebound, Reese Rolson. Rolson kicking it down the court. Rolson stands right around the end of the oval end. She gets it to number 24, Hadley Luke. Luke loses her dribble. Be Lady Raider ball. I think they're going to give it to the Lady Rams. I thought it went off Luke last. Just kind of went off her dribble. Have her be out of bounds. I guess be out of bounds against Mackenzie Williams. Be the closest Lady Raider. 4:41 remaining here in the third quarter. They inbound into Rolson. Rolson right side goes to Harrell. Harrell, top of the key. She's going to go left. Picks up her dribble. Gets it to number three, Rolson, through traffic. And Wilson's pass goes to Lurie, goes to Harrell. Harrell, pull-up shot, no good. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Raiders to be Ramball. 4:27 remaining here in the third quarter. Joining us here at Raider Gym. Thank you for joining us here on this Tuesday night. Number 24, Hadley Luke with the ball. Luke inbounds in to Benson. They tip it away. The Lady Raiders do a good job of tipping it away. However, they're going to say it went out of bounds. Last touch by the Raiders again. The Lady Ramball. Remember, timeout. Timeout on the floor. Timeout Paragould. I believe it's going to be a 30-second timeout. We're going to take it with him. Back in 30 seconds on the EAB Sports Network.
This is Keith Baird with Baird Auto Group. There's nothing that brings our community together like high school sports. No matter what the scoreboard says, it's a winning feeling just to be a part of it. At Baird, we want you to have the feeling anytime you come into one of our dealerships. Good credit, bad credit, no problem. Don't buy anywhere else until you shop at Baird location near you. Don't get a bad deal, get a Baird deal. Because why pay more?
Saving service, great selection too.
Lady Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton TV. 4:23 remaining here in the third quarter. 41-24 is the score. Raiders have the advantage up by 17 points here at Raider Gym. Paragould inbounds into Rolson. Rolson in the corner. Goes over to Benson. Benson right wing. She makes a couple of spin moves. Shot fake. Pulls up from the elbow. Sinks it. Circus shot from Benson. 41-26, Raiders up by 15. Number one, Carmen McShan with the ball. McShan goes over to Bunga. Marshall, Marshall tries inside to Donna Douglas. Just a little too much on the pass. It goes out of bounds. 3:58 remaining here in the third. Number three, Rolson with the ball. Rolson bringing it down the court. Rolson stands at the right wing, kicks to Luke. Luke just fires a three. No good. Rebound, Bunga. Marshall, Marshall to Summer Morgan. Morgan on the fast break. Doesn't have the numbers. However, she Euro steps, gets fouled. She goes to the line to shoot two. Foul charge number 30. That's Haley Benson. That's her second personal, team foul number two. At the line shooting two is number 13, Summer Morgan. 3:43 remaining here in the third quarter. Morgan's first one is no good and off the right side of the rim. At the line shooting her second one is Morgan. Morgan, that one off the front iron of the rim. Rebound goes to the Lady Rams. Number three, Rolson with the ball. Rolson stands right side with it. She goes inside to Benson. Benson, couple of turnaround, fade away, gets it denied. Donna Douglas said not today. However, Harrell off the offensive rebound. Donna Douglas rebounds her three-point miss. A kick down to Summer Morgan. Morgan, hesitation move, going to the rack. She gets fouled. Go to the line. We just shoot another two. 3:18 remaining here in the third quarter. At the line, he's going to be shooting two. It's going to be Summer Morgan. Foul charge, number three, Reese Rolson. Her second personal team foul, number two. Raiders up by 15. Beyond the four. I thought she was in her shooting steps. However, they inbound in. Try to get it to Carmen McShann. However, Reese Rolson played good off the ball defense. Deflecting get away like a defensive back in football. Number one, McShann inbounds into number 13, Summer Morgan. Morgan with the ball. Morgan crosses over a few times. Now going to go right side with it. Dribbles it back out. Kicks to McKenzie Williams. Williams to Donna Douglas. Douglas one dribble. Misses her first one. Spin move, turn around. Misses the second one. Rebound this time to Madison Harrell. Harrell out to Rolson. Rolson is going to set up the offense. Rolson at the volleyball line goes to Benson. Benson into Lurie. Lurie loses the grip. They're going to say it's out by Bunga Marshall. Lady Ram ball. Lady Raiders can bring in two subs, bringing in number 25, Kiki Brown, and number 5, Aubrey Butler. Lady Raiders bringing in, they'll have four seniors on the court, and then Summer Morgan, the freshman. Number 3, Rolson with the ball. Rolson to Benson. Benson on the elbow goes to Kiki Brown. Lady Raiders with the takeaway. Number 1, McShann bringing it down the court. Running the fast break, kicks to Morgan, wide open in the corner. Morgan jab steps, kick back to McShann. McShann pull up three, no good. And rebound's going to go out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Raiders went right off the rim. 2:30 remaining here in the third quarter. 41-26, Raiders up by 15. Number 3, Rolson with the ball. Rolson is going to go right side with it. Has a screen. Pulls up wide open in the corner. Sinks her shot. Makes it 41-29. Raiders still up by 12 here at Raider Gym. Summer Morgan with the ball. Morgan right wing. Crosses over a few times. Goes to Aubrey Butler. Butler at the top of the key. Makes a couple of step moves. Kicks to number 1, Carmen McShann. McShann left wing. She's going to drive the left side of the rim. Up and under. Trick shot. No good. Rebound to the Lady Rams. Number 3, Reese Rolson bringing it down the court. Rolson. Hesitation move, step back for three, no good. Rebound, Aubrey Butler. Butler's going to be fouled, and fouls him against number 3, Reese Rolson. Her third personal team foul, number 3. 1:44 remaining here in the third quarter. Raiders up by 12. 41-29 is the score. Back in the game for the Lady Raiders is number 44, D1 Donna Douglas. Coming in for the juice. Number 1, Carmen McShann bringing it down the court on a walk. Shan goes to the volleyball line, kicks to Butler, right wing. Butler crosses over, goes left side with it. Butler's going to be fouled. Foul charge against number 30, Haley Benson. Her third personal team foul, number 4. Raiders just one foul away from that bonus. Inbound to the ball is going to be number 5, Aubrey Butler. Butler runs into D1 Donna. Donna back to Butler. Butler stands on the left, right wing. She goes left, goes to Kiki Brown. Kiki to McShann. McShann drives right, kicks the Kiki Brown off a screen and roll. They kick the Butler wide open. Butler pull up three, no good. D1 Donna with the rebound. D1 Donna with the putback. 43-29 is the score. Raiders back up by, I believe, 14. Number 3, Rolson with the ball. Rolson to Benson. Benson inside to Lurie. Lurie. Layup up off the glass, makes it 43-31. Raiders still up by 12. 55 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Number 1, McShann with it. McShann crosses over. She's going to drive the right side. Have a foul on the floor. We have foul against number 30, Benson. Her fourth personal team foul, number 5. Going to send number 1, Carmen McShann, to the line to shoot two. 47 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. At the line, shooting two is number 1, Carmen McShann. McShann, the senior for this Lady Raider team. First shot up, first shot off the right side of the rim. No good. Going to go off the right side of the rim. Still has that second shot. Number 1, McShann, second shot up. Second shot is money. Makes it 44-31, Raiders up by 13. Number 3, Reese Rolson bringing it down the court for the Lady Rams. 40 seconds remaining here in the third. About 30 seconds on the shot clock. About a 10-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Number 3, Rolson left wing now. crosses over, kicks to Hadley Luke. Luke going to drive the right side. He's going to make a couple of spins. She's going to be fouled. I say foul against Kiki Brown. It's going to be Kiki's second personal team foul, number three. That's going to take away the shot clock in the rest of the third quarter. 25 seconds is all that remains. Reese Rolston, that's Hadley Luke set to inbound. They're going to try to get it to Rolston. They do. Rolston going to go left side with it. Now coming back to the high corner on the right side. 14 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. They get it to Benson. Benson with the ball goes to Luke. Luke drives left side. Now going back right. Passes to Benson. Benson tries to go into Lurie. Ball's going to roll out of bounds with 4.4 seconds remaining here in the third. Here's the Lady Raider ball. Lady Raiders going to probably roll it in, try to get a last second shot. Kermit Shan lets it bounce a few times. 3 seconds. They get it to Jessica Collins. Collins pulls up, long range heave, no good. Looked really close from this perspective. Bounce off the right side of the rim. That goes away from scoring. Lady Raiders up by 13. 44-31 is the score. We're going to take a 6 second break and come back around the fourth quarter. Back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
Hey there, Northeast Arkansas. This is John Moore of Arkansas Superstore on Highway 49 in Brooklyn. Here to tell you that we're flipping the script on car buying. Don't stand for bait and switch tactics.
That's holding.
We believe in transparency and trust. You deserve the car you want with a payment much lower than your rent. Arkansas Superstore is here to make sense of it all for you. Come over and find your dream ride. You're approved. When the banks say no, I say yes. Visit us today at 11580 Highway 49 North in Brooklyn or online at ArkansasSuperstore.com.
You're listening to the Nettleton Raiders on Bob FM, 101.3 KIYS HD2 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, KIYS HD2, K231 BB College City Jonesboro, KIYS HD4 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, and KIYS HD4 K267 AS Piggott.
Welcome you in here to Raider Basketball 101.3, the Bob FM here in Jonesboro. We're here at Raider Gym. Lady Raiders have the advantage right now, looking for another good quarter of play. Last quarter, Lady Raiders were only held to 8 points by the Rams. They kind of had a breakout quarter, scoring 18 points. Excuse me, that's a 12. I cannot read my dad's writing. He's not a great when it comes to writing skills. Number three, Rolston with the ball. Rolston, number 33, Harrell. Harrell shot fakes, drives the right side. A little bit of a floater fadeaway, gets it to fall, makes it 44-33. Raiders still up by 11 here at Raider Gym. You're joining us here on 101.3, the Bob FM. Number one, McShan over to number five, Butler. Butler left wing, goes to Kiki Brown, top of the key. Kiki inside to D1, Donna. Donna turns around, gets fouled, to the line to shoot two. Foul charge against number 20. That's be Lurie. That's Anisha Lurie. That's going to be that young lady's second personal team foul, number one. 7:26 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Donna Douglas, first one just a little too flat. Did not get it to fall. However, she has that second one at the line. Douglas shot up. Shot is in this time. Makes it 45-33. Raiders up by 12. Number three, Reese Rolston bringing it down the court. Rolston, she's going to go left side with it. They're going to have a foul on the floor. It was going to be against number one, Carmen Shan. That's her first personal team foul, number one. 7:18 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Make sure you do stick around for the Barnes postgame show. Build it better with Barnes. Number three, Rolston with the ball. Rolston, she's going to stand back at the volleyball line, drive right side, driving to the rack, floater up, floater no good, rebound out of bounds, be Lady Raider ball. 7:05 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Lady Raiders off of the rebound that goes out. The Raiders bringing it down the court. Number one, McShan with it. McShan walks it across the timeline, crosses 28 seconds. She kicks over a number four, five. That's Butler. Butler back to McShan. McShan pull up three. That one is good. Makes it 48-33. Raiders are up by 15. Number three, Reese Rolston bringing it down the court. Rolston, she's going to in and out move, drive right side. We're going to have a foul on the court. Trying to see what the indication was. It was the far side ref. He hasn't made an indication yet. Now against number one, Carmen McShan. Her second personal team foul, number two. Number 24, Luke, is set to inbound. We're going to have a timeout on the floor. 6:38 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Timeout, Paragold. I believe it's going to be a 60-second timeout. We're going to take it with it back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
Hello, I'm estate planning and elder law attorney Chad Oldham. More and more often today, I hear clients tell me that the only thing golden about the golden years is that it takes all the gold to grow old. Don't be a victim of rising health care and nursing home costs. Be prepared. Have a plan. Contact us today to find out how we help our clients protect and preserve assets for family and future generations. The Oldham Law Firm, 603 Southwest Drive in Jonesboro, or visit us on the web at oldhamlawfirm.com.
Evolve Bank & Trust offers a variety of residential and consumer loans, specializing in unique products and services while providing individualized customer service designed to fit your needs. Whether you're buying your first home, a new car, or building your dream home, Evolve Bank & Trust has the personal loan products you need to realize your dreams today. Call Evolve Bank & Trust at 870-933-2480. Stop in to see them at 111 East Huntington Suite A or visit them online at getevolve.com. Evolve Bank & Trust, making banking personal again. Evolve Bank & Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Lady Raider basketball here on 101.3 the Bob FM and Nettleton Television. We're glad you're joining us here on this Tuesday evening of 5A East Conference play. Lady Raiders are coming into the fourth quarter right now up by 15. Fourth quarter is not over yet. 6:38 remaining in the fourth. Number 24, Hadley Luke for Paragould is set to inbound. Luke goes to Rolson. Rolson stands at the volleyball line. A crossover a few times, kicks to Madison Harrell. Harrell right wing skips a pass to Rolson. Rolson's going to drive the left side baseline. Loses the grip, gets it to Benson, however. Benson's shot is no good. Lady Raiders on the takeaway. Number one, McShan with it. Get it number five. That's Butler. Butler back to McShan. McShan's going to go left side with it. Goes inside to D1 Donna. Donna to Jessica Cullen on a backdoor cut. However, the layup is no good. Number 20, Anaja Lurie with the ball. Goes number three. That's Reese Rolson. Rolson with it. She stands right around the volleyball line, gets a screen, doesn't use it, kicks out to Harrell on the right wing instead. Harrell pulls up fadeaway, makes it 48-35. Good shot from Madison Harrell right there. 5:45 remaining in the fourth quarter. Number one, Carmen McShan bringing it down the court. McShan walks it across the timeline, setting the pace for the Raiders, kicks to Aubrey Butler left wing. Butler gets a screen from Brown, uses it. Gets another one from Douglas. Now she kicks out to number one, McShan, right wing. McShan picks up her dribble, kicks a cutting Jessica Cullens. Cullens gets fouled. She goes to the line to shoot two. Foul is going to be against number 33, Madison Harrell. That is her first personal team foul, number two. At the line, shooting twos, number two, Jessica Cullens. 5:23 remaining in the fourth quarter. Cullens misses her first one. However, she has a second one at the line. 48-35 is the score. Raider Jim still slowly filling up, about 5:20 away from the end of the fourth. Jessica Cullen misses her second one, number 33. Harrell kicks out to Rolson. Rolson dribbling it down the court. Has a little skip and a run. Now she's going to go right with it. She's going to thought about driving, pulls it back out, picks up her dribble, making a couple of pivot steps, kicks the inside to Benson. Benson, one dribble, pivots around, fade away, makes it. I thought it was going to bounce out for a second. However, got the Lady Ram bounce. 48-37 is the score. Lady Raiders are up by 11. Number one, McShan over to number 13. That is Summer Morgan. Morgan with the ball, stands around the volleyball line. She goes to Jessica Cullens. Cullens left wing goes to Kiki Brown. Brown dribbling to McShan. McShan goes back door. They kick to Summer Morgan wide open in the corner. Morgan misses it. Jessica Cullens gets fouled on her putback. Be Lady Raider Cullens at the line shooting two. Foul against number 30. That's Benson, her fifth personal, and team foul number three. Benson has to come out. We're going to have a timeout on the floor. Sandra Tate called everybody over to the bench. However, they're going to keep the Sanja. I'm just going to draw up a play. Number two, Jessica Collins, is going to be at the line shooting two. I think they have to have somebody down there to rebound. That's why they're holding off play. Benson still hasn't came out yet. Be a technical foul on a late substitution off of a fouled out player. They're pull everybody back. Collins will shoot her two. And then the Lady Raiders are going to have a technical free throw challenge. 4:28 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Everybody's going to float back to the half court area now. First of the two free throws going to be number two, Jessica Collins. These are the technical shots. Collins got fouled under the rim by Benson. Benson's fifth personal. Collins makes her first one, makes it 49-37. Hey, Raiders up by 12. Collins, second one up. Second one no good. And Summer Morgan's going to come down there and take the technical shots. 49-37, 4:28 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Make sure you do stick around for our Barton's postgame show. Build it better with Barton's. After the Barton's postgame show, we'll have our first National Bank pregame show of the boys' game. Morgan makes her first one at the free throw line. Raiders back up by 13. Morgan, second one is good as well. Makes it 51-37. Lady Raiders with the momentum here in the fourth quarter. Lady Raiders get the ball back after four consecutive free throws. They get it to number one, Carmen McSham. McSham bringing it down the court. Goes back to Summer Morgan. Morgan back to McSham. McSham at the volleyball line. Crosses over a few times. She gets a screen right side. She's going to the rack. Euro step. Gets her shot blocked, however, under the rim. It'll be blocked by number 20, Anisha Lurie. However, it's still going to be a Lady Raider ball. 4:16 remaining here in the fourth. 51-37 is the score. Raiders are up by 14. Number one, Carmen McShann is set to inbound. Lady Raiders have the horizontal stack going. They go inside to Douglas. Douglas loses the grip. They're going to say it went off of the Lady Raiders. Be Lady Ramball. 4:13 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Reese Rolson bringing it down the court for the Lady Rams. Rolson now starting a walk across. It's a number 33, Harrell. Harrell driving the left side, pulls it back out, picks up her dribble. Summer Morgan entangles the ball up, gets a jump ball. It's going to be a Lady Raider ball. 3:58 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Thank you for joining us here on this Tuesday night on either 101.3 The Bob FM, part of the EAB Sports Group, or Nettleton TV. However you're joining us, we're glad you did. Number one, McShann with the ball. McShann kicks over to number 13, Morgan. Morgan crosses over, goes over to number 25, Kiki Brown. Brown left wing, kicks to Jessica Collins, top of the key. Now over to number 13, Summer Morgan. Morgan, 14 seconds on the shot clock, picks up her dribble, kicks number one, McShann. McShann to Butler, Douglas. And Douglas misses her first one. We have foul on the floor, foul against Donna Douglas. That's Douglas's third personal, team foul number three. 3:26 remaining here in the fourth quarter, 51-37. Raiders up by 14. Reese Rolson bringing it down the court for the Lady Rams. Rolson on a jog across the timeline, kicks to Harrell. Harrell's going to drive the baseline, kicks out to Rolson. Rolson, floater up, floater no good. Rebound to the Lady Raiders. Summer Morgan with the ball. Morgan on a fast pace down the timeline, up and under layup, no good. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Raiders. Be Lady Ram ball. 3:05 remaining in the fourth quarter. Lady Raiders up by 14 here in the fourth quarter. Make sure you do stick around for the Barton's postgame show. Build it better with Barton. Number three, Rolson bringing the ball down the court. Rolson on a skip. Goes to number 33, Madison. Harrell. Harrell with it. Going to drive the baseline. Kicks to Rolson on a cut. Rolson touches it out of bounds. Be a Lady Raider ball. Into the ball game for the Raiders. Bringing back in number 11, number 22, Bunga Marshall and Taylor Thomas coming in for the Lady Raiders. They're in for Jessica Cullen and Summer Morgan. Carmen McSham bringing it down the court. She's going to walk it down the court. 28 seconds as she crosses on the shot clock. Gets it to Taylor Thomas. Thomas played a little bit of stall ball. Kicks the bung to Marshall. Marshall now starting her dribble. Kicks to Thomas. Thomas hesitation. Drives to the rack. Euro step. Layup up and in. Makes it 53-37. Number three, Rolson with the ball. Rolson, she's going to go right side with it. She's going to drive. Kicks it back out. Setting up the Paragold offense. She's right side hesitation. Drives the baseline. Gets fouled. Foul, I believe it's going to be against number 44, Donna Douglas. Her fourth personal. Team foul number four. 2:11 remaining in the fourth. Lady Raiders have four fouls right now as a team. So does the Paragold Rams. Both those individuals have four fouls each. They get it into Rolson. Rolson kicks out to number one, Farmer. That is a Farmer back into the game for the Lady Paragolds. They get it number three. Back to Rolson, back to Farmer. Farmer right side corner. Goes into Hadley. Luke. Luke turns around. Fade away. No good. Rebound Bunga. Marshall. Marshall to Taylor. Thomas. Thomas bringing it down the court. Thomas on a fast break. Euro step. Layup up. No good. Rebound. D1 Donna. Donna gets fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot two. See the indication. Foul against. Leave. Called it against 33. Madison Harrell. Could not see the referee's hands. Looked like a 23. But that's Harrell's second personal. Douglas makes her first one. Douglas has a handful of points. Week 13 on the night after that first free throw. Makes it 54-37. Raiders have the 17-point advantage back in the game for the Lady Raiders. Number 35, Kaylee Franklin. The line shooting her second one. Okay, another player coming out of the game. Might have a little bit of blood either dripping from part of her body or on her jersey. Both of those would take you out of the game until it's cleaned up. Douglas misses her second one. However, Kaylee Franklin with the rebound and putback makes it 56-37. Raiders up by 19. Number three, that's Reese Rolson with the ball. Rolson at the volleyball line. Gets a screen, doesn't use it. Now driving right. Drives the baseline. Up and under. She's fouled. And let's see who they're going to call against. Number 44, Donna Douglas. She shook her head. She walking off the court. That'd be our fifth personal. I take that back. They're going to call it against Carmen McShann. However, Donna Douglas is still coming out of the game anyways. Douglas has two subs coming in for. They're bringing in Keviana Gleason and number 10, Kalise Reed. For three, that's Rolson at the line. Her first one up. First one is good. Makes it 56-38. Wonder how they got that substitution off. There was usually they wait till after the first shot. However, they still subbed them in. Makes the second one. Makes it 56-39. Number 22, Taylor Thomas playing aggressive. Kicks the bunga Marshall. Marshall with it. Goes over to Thomas. Thomas back to Marshall. Marshall slowing it down a little bit. Gets it to Keviana Gleason. Gleason inside to Franklin. Franklin loses the grip on it. A Paragold with the steal. Reese Rolson with it. Goes to number two. That's Kaylee Metz. Metz back to Rolson. Goes to number 33, Harrell. Harrell back to Rolson. Rolson shot fake. Kicks inside to Luke. A little bit of semi-pro action. They go back to Rolson with it. Rolson to Harrell. Harrell top of the key almost. She goes number 24. That's Hadley Luke. She gets fouled. She goes to the line to shoot two. Foul is going to be charged against number 34, Keviana Gleason. That's her first personal team foul, number six. At the line, shooting number 24, Hadley Luke. Luke makes her first one, makes it 56-40. Raiders up by 16. 50.6 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter. Luke's second one up. Second one is good as well. Cuts the Lady Raider lead down to 15. Taylor Thomas with the ball off the inbound. On a very fast pace down the court. Slows it down after she crosses. Kicks over to Kalise Reed. Reed loses the grip on it. However, she gains it right back. Kicks the bunga Marshall. Marshall back to Kalise. Over to Keviana Gleason. Gleason going to drive right. Kicks back to Kalise. Kalise drives right. Kicks to Taylor Thomas. Thomas going to drive. Tries to get a pass to Kalise Reed and just goes off her fingers. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Raiders. 23 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter. Rolston going to drive it down the court on a jog. Kicks to Harrell. Harrell pull up three. No good. It is good. Had the last second bounce. I thought it was bouncing out. Gets it to fall. 56-44. Bunga Marshall, she's going to drive up and under. No good. Lady Raiders don't get the second rebound. They paragoed with it, and that's going to end the fourth quarter. That's all of the ladies' game. 56-44 is the final score. The Lady Raiders win it by 12. And we're going to swing it right into the Barnes postgame show after a quick break. We're about 2 minutes away from the Barnes postgame show, Build It Better with Barnes. We're going to take a quick two-minute break. When we come back, we're going to have the postgame show and flip it over to the First National Bank pregame show. Back in 2 minutes on the EAB Sports Network.
At Barton's, we see your commitment to making your project a success. From the pro up with the son that doesn't quit until it goes down, to the DIYer who faces each challenge head-on, our seasoned store partners support you every step of the way. Since 1885, Barton's has been the backbone of local communities for every type of project. From new construction to home remodel, our dedicated team is here to empower your project with local delivery options and a variety of complimentary project services, including expert kitchen planning. Visit your hometown team today and build it better with Barton's.
First Security has been putting our home state first since 1932, helping fellow Arkansans and their families buy homes, grow businesses, and build futures. Today, First Security is still committed to helping you bank better, providing local solutions and local support in the places we love too. It's community banking with people you know and people you know you can count on. First Security. Bank better. FSBank.com. Member FDIC.
Mom, I can't get my homework to upload.
Dad, my video game is froze again.
Babe, is our internet down again? I'm missing the big game.
Honey, I'm trying to make this online payment, but it just keeps buffering.
Get your life up to speed with high-speed internet from Empower Broadband. Empower's reliable service brings high-speed internet to even the most remote areas of Northeast Arkansas. With Empower Broadband, you can stream your favorite movies, video chat with loved ones, work from home without interruptions, and so much more. Empower Broadband. Life. Up to speed. For more info, visit empowerbroadband.com.
At First National Bank, our mortgage lending team knows what it takes to make a home and a superior home loan process. Simple, proven, and reliable service with competitive rates at a bank that already feels like home. Since 1889, that's been the First National Bank way, because for our people, this is home. Apply online at fnbank.net/mortgage. From our family to yours, welcome home. First National Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Lady Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. You're joining us for our Barton's postgame show. It's time for the Barton's postgame show, Build It Better with Barton's. We're glad you're joining us here on this Tuesday evening. We're going to wrap up what's left of the girls' game and swing it right into our First National Bank pregame show. The girls came out on top, final score 56-44, a lot closer than what we played them the first time. I believe that our girls did score 56 points the first time around. Paragould only scored 14. A very big difference, a very improved Paragould team tonight. We're going to break down the quarters. Number one, Carmen Chan, had 6 points. Number 11, Marshall, had 4. Number 13, Morgan, with 11. Williams had 9. Douglas with 12. Those are the starters for the Raiders. Off the bench, Butler had 5. Thomas with 2. Collins with 3. And Franklin with 4. Those are the players that came off the bench. And some of them got hot for the Raiders when they needed it. For the Paragould Rams, we'll kind of break it down we did for the Raiders. Break it down how the starters scored. Number 2, Metz did not score. Number 3, Rolson, had the nod. She had 12 points for the Lady Rams. Larry, number 20, and Nigel Larry had 8. Number 10, Hadley Luke with 10. Number 30, Benson had 2. Number 33, Harrell had 12. Got my numbers mixed up. I was just reading numbers at some point. Breaking down scoring quarter by quarter. First quarter, Lady Raiders outscored them 18-13. The second quarter, Lady Raiders outscored them 18-6, going into the half up 36-19. In the fourth quarter, the Paragould Rams outscored the Raiders 12-8. However, Lady Raiders were still up. They had Made the score up going into the fourth. Try to do the math real quick. 44-31 for the Paragould Rams. They outscored the Raiders again in the fourth quarter, 13-12. However, just a little too late. The Raiders take it all here, 56-44. Raiders with the win. That will push them for momentum going into the rounding out of conference play. Lady Raiders are tied in that fourth place position with Marion. All depends on how Marion does tonight and how the Lady Raiders finish out. Lady Raiders' last couple of games have the Paragould. They play Paragould tonight. They take on Batesville Friday. That's senior night. Make sure you do come out and support these Lady Raiders seniors and these Raiders seniors. I know they sure would appreciate all the Raider faithful here supporting them on their senior night. And the next week, they take on Valley View at Valley View and then Searcy at Searcy. If the Lady Raiders make the state tournament this year is at Searcy. The Raiders, we're going to flip it over to the First National Bank pregame show for this Raider basketball game. Before I do that, I did get a little carried away talking statistics. I forgot to name our JOSM player of the game. The player of the game is brought to you by Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. They've been getting you back in the game for more than 40 years. I'm going to give it to the Summer Morgan tonight. Morgan played well both sides of the ball. Had a couple of big fast breaks for the Lady Raiders. Swung a lot of momentum the Raider way. She had 11 points. Huge for the Raiders. We can give our JOSM player of the game to Summer Morgan. Now we're going to flip it to that First National Bank pregame show. Our pregame coverage is brought to you by First National Bank, where they put you first always. The Raiders are here playing the Paragould Rams. Last time these two teams met, the Raiders won it 65-50. The Raiders were led by number 22, Kobe Jamison. Jamison had 17 points for the Raiders. A very big asset for him. Paragould has a stud of their own. They had Jesse Ballou. Ballou had 26 points for the Rams. Be a good matchup here tonight. 5A East Conference play. Raiders and Paragould Rams warming up right now. About 3 minutes away from the beginning of tip-off. Raiders and Paragould Rams. We're going to name our starting lineups. Police predicted starting lineup, starting with the away team. Number 5, Zachary Fields, is a 5'10 senior. Number 10, 5'9 junior, Cole Chipman. Number 13, the 6'2 senior, Jesse Ballou. Number 22, a 6'2 senior, Caden Calhoun. Rounding it out, number 32, a 6'2 junior, Ricardo Casagrande. I'm assuming that's how you pronounce it. Spelled Casagrande. Go Casagrande until proven wrong in this scenario. Raiders have an outstanding season so far, 9-1 conference-wise. The Raiders played very huge all season. Their one loss coming to Marion at Marion. However, they beat the Patriots at Nettleton. A very big game for the Raiders. Raiders have a tough schedule ahead, however, take on Batesville. Batesville is a fun game. Raiders won that one by 20, but the toughest opponents are in the following week. The Raiders play Batesville Friday, and then that next week is Valley View, the tied for 2 seed right now. They beat Marion once. They play Marion next Friday. I think this Friday they take on, I'm trying to think, I believe it's going to be Greene County Tech. We'd be at Tech as well. The Raiders take on Valley View, and then that next Friday is Searcy. They play Searcy at Searcy. Be a very big game for the Raiders. If the Raiders keep playing how they play, it's still their fate as conference champion. We're going to take a quick minute and a half break. When we come back, we're going to have the rest of our First National Bank pregame show. Be back in a minute and a half on the EAB Sports Network.
At First National Bank, our mortgage lending team knows what it takes to make a home and a superior home loan process. Simple, proven, and reliable service with competitive rates at a bank that already feels like home. Since 1889, that's been the First National Bank way, because for our people, this is home. Apply online at fnbank.net/mortgage. From our family to yours, welcome home. First National Bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Hello, I'm estate planning and elder law attorney Chad Oldham. More and more often today, I hear clients tell me that the only thing golden about the golden years is that it takes all the gold to grow old. Don't be a victim of rising health care and nursing home costs. Be prepared. Have a plan. Contact us today to find out how we help our clients protect and preserve assets for family and future generations. The Oldham Law Firm, 603 Southwest Drive in Jonesboro, or visit us on the web at oldhamlawfirm.com.
Central Ford in Truman has your vehicle and your back. Call Central Ford today to schedule your service appointment. Central Ford Service Department is even open on Saturdays. Whether you need an oil change, tire rotation, wheel alignment, brake service, battery inspection, or full engine repair, you can count on the service team at Central Ford in Truman. Next time your vehicle needs maintenance, remember Central Ford. Professional, convenient, reliable. Central Ford, exit 29 off I-555 in Truman and online at centralfordtruman.com.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM. We're going to go ahead and break down how the starting lineups are going to be called. Looks like we had a little bit of them off, starting number 4, Lucas Deathridge. That's for the Paragord Rams. Also number 5, Zachary Fields. Number 22, Caden Calhoun. Number 32, I believe it's going to be Caden Dilport. Dilport played when we were there against the against Rams at Paragould. They have two 32s on their rosters, however. And they're bringing in number 40, Nate Brittingham. Paragould not starting Jesse Ballou tonight. A interesting choice for Mr. Ballou. He's dropped 26 against the Raiders at Paragould. The Raiders starting lineup, number 0, Taylor Smith, the 6'4 senior, the electrifying one, Taylor Smith. Number 3, 5'7, B3, Brandon Alexander. Boogie, electrifying defender for the Raiders. Number 14, JT14, Jamari Thomas, also getting the nod tonight. Number 22, the 6'3 junior for Jacoby Jamison. He likes to play down low, finish with the left hand, running it out. Number 30, the 6'7 senior, Deshaun Jackson. Raiders, that's their starting lineup on the night. Taylor, Brandon, Jamari, Kobe, and Deshaun. Raiders are going to probably jump Deshaun Jackson. That's their typical call. They're jumping against number 22, Caden Calhoun. Calhoun was one of the running backs for this Paragould football team this year. All-around athletic kid. Raiders bringing out the last second huddles. Raiders in their white uniforms, gold lettering, and gold down the hems and sides. Paragould in their road reds, wearing the red uniforms, blue down the side, and the hems and white lettering. Caden Calhoun and Deshaun Jackson set to jump it away. The ball is in the air. Tip goes to Kobe Jamison. Raiders going to get the ball first. Number 3, Brandon Alexander, walks it down the court, setting up the Raider offense. Alexander, he's going to go left side, now coming back right. Goes to Taylor Smith. Smith to Kobe Jamison. Jamison out to Jamari Thomas. Thomas setting up the offense. Kicks out to Alexander. Alexander to Jamison. Jamison pass fake. Kicks wide open. Thomas. Thomas for 3. No good. Rebound Zach Fields. He kicks out to number 4, Lucas Deathridge. Deathridge loses the grip. They get it to Jamari Thomas. Thomas fast break. Lays it in. I thought he was going to get up there and dunk one for Raider faithful. However, he sticks with the old left-hand layup. 2-0 is the score. 7:15 remaining in the first quarter. Number 4, Deathridge, over to Brittingham. Brittingham with it. Makes a hesitation move. Kicks to Dilport. Dilport, number 4. That's Deathridge now inside to Fields. Fields to Brittingham. Brittingham, corner 3 is good. Makes it 2-3. Number 3, Brandon Alexander, is going to bring it down the court. You know, jog it across the timeline at a solid pace. He's going to fake left. Now he's going left. Goes number 22. That's Jamison. Jamison in the corner. Pull up long range two. Rebound to Cade and Calhoun. Calhoun gets it at Brittingham. Now to Fields. Fields bringing it down the court on the right side. Kicks to Brittingham, top of the key. Goes number 32, Dilport. Dilport to Fields, left corner. Now they get it to Dethridge. Dethridge to Brittingham. Brittingham to Calhoun. Down low, Calhoun spins around, kicks to Dethridge. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paragol B. Raider ball. 6:22 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders have the disadvantage right now. They're down by 1 point. However, it's still super early here in this game. Number three, Brandon Alexander, B3, bringing it down the court. Hands it off to Jamari Thomas. Thomas drives down, kicks it to Kobe Jamison. Jamison can be called with a traveling violation. It's going to be Paragold ball. Jamison just didn't have his mind made up where he was going with it, and then took that extra step. Be Paragold with the ball. Number 32, Dilport with it over to Dethridge. Dethridge going to work it down the court, kicks back to Dilport. Dilport gets called with the over the back. He stepped over the line, then came back around on his pivot foot. The Raiders with the ball. Number 22, Jamison is set to inbound. Jamison gonna move a little closer to half court. He goes to B3, Brandon Alexander. Raiders gonna set up the offense. B3 on a jog, hands it off to Jamari Thomas. Thomas to Jamison right side. Jamison to Taylor Smith on the right wing. He crosses over. He's going to the rack. Floater from Taylor Smith sinks it. Makes it 4-3. Number 40, Brittingham. Over to number 4, Dethridge. Dethridge with it. He's going to go down the left sideline. Now going right. Kicks to Brittingham. Brittingham over to number 5. That's Fields. Fields to Cole Shipman. Shipman to Brittingham. He goes inside to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun to Fields, right side. Now to Brittingham on the left wing. Brittingham to Dethridge, top of the key to Field. Fields to Calhoun down low. Calhoun reverse layup, no good. Rebound to Ashawn Jackson. Deshaun to Taylor Smith. Smith skip pass down low to Jamari Thomas. Thomas throws it off of Chipman. Going to be Raider ball. Good basketball IQ play by Thomas. He knew he was fading out of bounds. Probably shouldn't catch it. Threw it off Chipman. Good idea from JT14, Jamari Thomas. 5:11 remaining here in the first quarter. Inbound into Deshaun Jackson. Jackson back to Thomas. Thomas to Jamison. Jamison pulls up from the free throw line. Makes it look easy. Sinks his shot. 6-3 is the score. Raiders steal the inbound. However, Taylor Smith's going to step on the line. Going to be Raiders. Rams with the ball off of the Raiders step out. 4:59 remaining here in the first quarter. Into the ball game for Paragold, number 13, Jesse Ballou. Ballou with the ball now. Ballou's going to be picked up by Jamari Thomas. Ballou going to go left side with it. He goes to Cole Chipman. Chipman with the ball. Kicks out to Fields. Fields right wing, skips past to Brittingham. Brittingham drives right, spin move, fade away, air balls. Rebound Deshaun Jackson. Rebound Raiders. Jamari Thomas off of the Taylor Smith with the ball. Goes to Jamison. Jamison goes to Alexander. Alexander now to Jamari Thomas. Thomas right wing. Number 22, Jamison. Jamison skip pass. Gets a and one. Jamison wasn't a skip pass. It was a skip hop. Hop step as they call it. Don't know what I was thinking. My brain got all clustered. However, he makes the and one. He'll go to the line to shoot one with 4:26 remaining here in the first. Foul charge against Caden Calhoun. His first personal team foul, number one. At the line shooting one, Kobe Jamison. Jamison, the leading scorer right now with 4 points, misses his free throw, still at four. Jesse Ballou with the rebound. He goes to Brittingham. Brittingham skips down to Chipman. Chipman, number five, that's Fields. Fields drives, kicks to Calhoun. Calhoun kicks to number 40, Brittingham. Brittingham drives the baseline, picks up his dribble, goes inside to Calhoun, however stolen by number 22, Jamison. Jamison to Taylor Smith. Smith going to the rack and dunks on Cole Chipman. What a dunk. Taylor Smith cocked it back behind his head and just posterized him. 3:55 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders up 10-3. Raiders up by 7. Chipman with the ball. Chipman, he goes to Jesse Ballou. Ballou, he's going to drive the rack, lose the grip on it, and it's going to be Raider ball. I'm going to say it went off his knee. Raiders take possession right back after the Taylor Smith dunk. That usually electrifies the whole Raider team. when Taylor Smith gets up and throws one down like that. 3:40 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders up by 7. Brandon Alexander is going to bring it down the court. Alexander goes to Taylor Smith. Smith, the right wing, makes a couple of moves, kicks to Kobe Jamison. Jamison loses the grip, gains it back, kicks to Jamari Thomas. Thomas shot fake, kicks back to Jamison. Jamison free throw line shot, no good. Rebound Jesse Ballou. Ballou kicks down to Fields. Fields on a fast break. Going to kick number 10, excuse me, 32, Dilport. Thought it was 10. It looked like a 10 from this angle. It's a weird angle up here in the Indiana Baptist broadcast position. Indiana Baptist Healthcare for the next entry. However, Dilport makes the floater. Number 22, Jamison to number 0, Taylor Smith. Smith step back, 3-point shot. No good. Rebound Jesse Ballou. Ballou takes it down the court, kicks to Dilport. Dilport picked up by Smith. They go to Brittingham. Brittingham going to drive, kicks to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun kicks to Jesse Ballou. Ballou left wing goes to number 32, Dilport. Dilport hands it off. Number 5, that's Zachary Fields. Fields going to drive right, goes to Ballou. Ballou picked up by B3. They get it to Calhoun, top of the key. Now to Zach Fields. Fields into Calhoun. Calhoun, layup is up. Layup is good. Timeout, timeout, Paragol. 2:30 remaining here in the first quarter. Raiders up by 3, 10-7. Back in 30 seconds on the EAB Sports Network.
Play It Again Sports wants to pay you money.
Now that I have your attention, Play It Again Sports in Jonesboro wants to buy your used sports equipment. You heard me right. If you have something that's either outgrown or no longer being used, bring it to Play It Again Sports now. They're looking for youth and adult baseball and softball equipment, golf, weights and workout equipment, disc golf, you name it. Play It Again Sports can turn it into cash for you. Go buy Play It Again Sports at the corner of Highland and Caraway in Jonesboro.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton TV. We're glad you're joining us here Tuesday night for Raider basketball. Girls took the first game of the series. Boys playing the second one now. They're up 10-7 against a tough Paragould Ram team. Raiders going to inbound into Jamari Thomas. Once the ball is back in play, Jamison is set to inbound. They inbound into Thomas now. Thomas is going to jog it down the court. Thomas going to go right side with it. Makes a crossover move. Now he kicks to number 30, Jackson. Jackson to Q Thompson. Good to see Q out there for the Raiders. They get it inside to Jackson. Jackson off two, throws it down. Holy cow. Deshaun said he wanted a dunk. 12-7. Q Thompson picks the pocket of Fields. Raiders back with it. Number 22, Jamison with it. Jamison's going to drive. Pulls it back out. Kicks to Taylor Smith. Smith spot up three. Bang, count it. Taylor Smith for three. Raiders are getting hot. 15-7. Raiders up by 8. Number 5, Fields with the ball. Fields over to Brittingham. Brittingham left wing. Pulls it back out. Goes back to Fields. Fields over to Ballou. Jesse Ballou with it. He goes left. Goes to number 23. That's Wyatt Echols. Echols to Fields for three. No good. Air ball. Rebound Raiders. Jamari Thomas on the transition, a couple behind the back moves. He's going to go right side with it, hands it off to Taylor. Taylor, long range three, could not make it. Out of the angle, just missed it a little left. Paragould kicks down to Ballou. Ballou gets a three of his own, makes it 15-10. 1:10 remaining here in the first quarter. Jamari Thomas bringing it down the court. Jamari Thomas is going to drive. Kicks out to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson going through contact, making his layup. 17-10. Raiders up by 7. Number 5, Zach Fields with the ball. Fields guarded by Q Thompson. Fields, a couple of spin moves. Now he's going all the way right. Kicks to number 40, Brittingham. Brittingham to Ballou. Ballou spot up three. No good. Rebound Echols. Echols makes his layup. Makes it 17-12. It's a 5-point game. Jamari Thomas bringing it down the court on a slow jog. Jamari gets a screen, uses the screen. Now he drives the baseline. Jamari out to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson to Taylor Smith. Smith pulls up for three. That one is money. Taylor Smith getting hot behind the arch, 20-12. He has 10 points on the night, half of the Raiders' points. Number 13, Ballou with the ball. Ballou's going to drive, kicks to Dilport. Dilport misses his layup. Rebound Nettleton. Taylor Smith with the ball. Taylor Smith on a fast break. Kicks to Jamari Thomas. We're going to have an offensive charge against Taylor. That's Taylor's first personal team foul, number 1. We have a sub into the game. They're bringing in number 10, TJ Whitney, and number 12, Cam Bobo. Two sophomores for this Raider team. Two impressive young players. and they have a very bright future here full of Raider basketball. Paragould inbounds in. They get it right back to Jesse Ballou. Ballou playing fast, pulls up from the free throw line, sinks his shot. Very impressive play from Ballou. Went coast to coast, sinks his layup, makes it 20-14 to end the first quarter. We're going to take a 60-second break. When we come back, we're going to have the second quarter. Back in 60 on the EIB Sports Network.
You love your truck, and Plaza Tire Service is here to help you make it even better. We've got wheels, leveling kits, and of course, the area's largest selection of light truck tires. With ATs and mud tires up to 35s and bigger, Plaza Tire Service has you covered. The pros at Plaza Tire Service can help you select a great combination that will work with your truck. Plus, with our Plaza Tire Service card or no credit needed financing, your upgrades can be easy on your budget. So take your truck from stock to spectacular with Plaza Tire Service.
Yeah. NEA Baptist Women's Clinic is now accepting prenatal appointments. Ladies, if you're expecting, get the prenatal care you and baby need and treat yourself to an A-rated delivery experience when you combine the expert team of labor and delivery nurses with the prenatal care in our women's clinic. Call 936-8000 to schedule a prenatal appointment with one of our obstetricians at the NEA Baptist Women's Clinic. Meet the team and learn more at neabaptistclinic.org. NEA Baptist, we put the A in baby.
Raider basketball here on 101.3, the Bob FM and Nettleton Television. Joining us here for our second quarter action of Raider, the boys team, just the Raiders as they call them. 20-14 is the score. Raiders up by 6. Jesse Ballou inbounds into Dilport. Caden Dilport with it. He's picked up by Taylor Smith. Dilport kicks out to Ballou. Ballou guarded by Q Thompson. They kick to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun back over to Dilport. Dilport gets a screen. Kicks out to Chipman. Chipman in the corner. Go back to Dilport to Brittingham to Ballou. Ballou right wing drives left side. Loses the grip. Gets it back. Having to get it to number 32. Dilport. Dilport for three. TJ Whitney with the rebound. TJ out to Taylor Smith. Raiders on a fast-paced offense. They get it into TJ Whitney. Whitney hop step. They're going to call a jump ball. It's going to be Raider way. Raiders are going to get the ball. 7:27 remaining here in the second quarter. Raiders up by 6. Cam Bobo is set to inbound. A couple of screens down low. They inbound into number 10, TJ Whitney. Go out to number 12, Cam Bobo. Bobo bringing it around the horn. And now going right side with it. Made it all the way around, almost in the right corner. It goes out to number 30, Deshaun Jackson. Jackson to Q Thompson. Thompson pulls up from three, wide open. Misses it just a little right. Cole Chipman with the rebound. And Cole Chipman picks up his dribble, kicks out to Brittingham. Brittingham, top of the key. He's going to drive right side with it. Kicks out to Chipman. Chipman for three. That one is good. Makes it 20-17. Raiders still up by three, however. 6:50 remaining here in the second quarter. Cam Bobo with it. Bobo playing very fast. He hesitates, drives the baseline. Cam Bobo up and under, makes his layup, makes it 22-17. Have a indication from the ref. Not sure what it is. They're going to give the ball back to Blue, and Blue's going to try again. They inbound into Chipman. Chipman with it. Chipman going to bring it down the court on a jaw. They kick out to Blue. Blue to Brittingham. Brittingham, jab steps, goes right, going to the rack, floater up. He's fouled. For the line to shoot two. 6:28 remaining here in the second quarter. 22-17 is the score. Foul against Cam Bobo. His first personal team foul, number one. At the line shooting two is Nate Brittingham. He makes his first one. 22-18. Raiders still have a 4-point advantage. Brittingham at the line. Second one underway. Second one is good. Makes it 22-19. Whitney inbounds into Bobo. Bobo's going to bring it down the court on a slow jog. Going to now drive right side. Makes the hesitation move. Goes back left. Floater and one. Count the basket. Cam Bobo. He's making some offensive plays. Typically, coach have Cam Bobo be a spot-up shooter. He's driving the rim, getting fouled. Good athleticism plays from Cam Bobo. Sub into the game for the Raiders. Number two, Braylon Green coming in for number zero, Taylor Smith. Foul charge to number 10, Cole Chipman. His first personal team foul, number one. Bobo at the line. His first one is underway. First one up. First one is good. Makes it 25-19. 6:15 remaining here in the second quarter. Number five, Zachary Fields with the ball. It goes to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun pivot move, kicks back to Fields. Fields with it. He drives right side. Now kicks to Nate Brittingham. Brittingham into Calhoun. Calhoun throws it to Deshaun Jackson. Raiders on the takeaway. Number 12, Cam Bobo with it. Bobo bringing it down the court. He's going to get a screen. Go right. Spot up three from Cam Bobo. No good. Just rims out. Number 13, Jesse Ballou with the rebound. He goes to Nate Brittingham. Brittingham makes a few crossover moves. Drives to the rack. Intercepted. Here comes the Raiders. Q Thompson with it. Q pulls it back out. Sets up the offense. He goes to Bobo. Bobo now top of the key with it. Came from the right wing. Now going back to the right wing. Crosses over. He's going to drive left. Kicks to TJ Whitney. Whitney shot fakes. Going to drive right. Hands it off. Number two, Braylon Green. They go back to Cam Bobo with it. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Cam Bobo drawing up the play. Now 10 seconds. They get a screen. They're going to go right. Bobo to Braylon Green. Back to Cam Bobo. Bobo to Q Thompson. Wide open left wing three. No good. Rebound Zach Fields. Fields bringing it down the court. Fields drawing it back. Kicks to Jesse Ballou. Ballou's going to drive right. Kicks out to Brittingham. Brittingham spot up three. Sinks it. Makes it 25-22. Raiders lead cut down to three. 4:48 remaining here in the second quarter. Make sure you do stick around for the Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Cavanaugh Auto Group. You can check out their new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. Deshaun Jackson over to TJ Whitney. Whitney for three. Long range. Doesn't make it. Rebound Jesse Ballou. Ballou skips it down to Cole Chipman. Chipman with it. He passes out to number 13. That's Ballou. Ballou to Fields to Brittingham. Brittingham kicks out to Chipman on a drive. Chipman corner three is good. We're all tied up here at Raider Gym. 25-25. Timeout on the floor. Timeout Nettleton. With 4:16 remaining here in the second quarter. Be a 30-second timeout. Back in 30 on the EAB Sports Network.
Nettleton High School Athletics is brought to you by Gateway Tire and Service Center and Toyo Tires, where there's always one thing you can count on. We go the distance for you. Before you hit the road for a trip across country or across town, drop by Gateway Tire and Service Center and check out the great deals on Toyo Tires. Whether it's tires or auto repair, you can always count on one thing. At Gateway Tire and Toyo Tires, we go the distance for you. At Gateway Tire in Jonesboro, we go the distance for you.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton TV. 4:16 remaining here in the half. Make sure you do stick around for the Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Halftime is presented by the Cavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Cavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. Jamari Thomas bringing it down the court for the Raiders. He's going to go right side with it. Stands about on the right wing. Gets a screen. Doesn't use it. Kicks out to A.D. Blackburn. Blackburn to Cam Bobo. Bobo to Kobe Jamison. Jamison going to drive over to number 14. That's Jamari Thomas. Thomas to 80. 80 back to number 14. Thomas. Thomas to Bobo. Bobo for three. No good. Rebound goes to off of number 40, Brittingham. 80, Blackburn and Brittingham were going for it. Just went off Brittingham's foot. Be Raider ball under their own goal. Shot clock will reset. 35 seconds back on the shot clock. They inbound into number 12. That's Cam Bobo. Bobo skips into 80 Blackburn. Blackburn turns around, gets his shot blocked. However, Jamison with the rebound. Jamison's left-hand layup. First one no good. Second one neither. We're going to have a jump ball. Jump ball arrow is pointing Pairgold away. Pairgold's going to have possession. We're still all tied up here at 25 here at Raider Gym. 3:33 remaining here in the second. Number 13, Jesse Ballou over to Zach Fields. Fields jogging it down the court. Going to spin move, turn around. Fields skips it down to Brittingham. Brittingham left wing goes to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun holds on to it. He kicks over to number 5, Fields. Fields hesitation, drives. Ball stolen. Cam Bobo on the fast break. Loses the grip. I'm going to say it went off of Jesse Ballou. He's the closest pair goal to Ram. Cam Bobo regains possession. He's going to inbound it out of bounds. Bobo inbounds into number 14, Jamari Thomas. Thomas bringing it down the court. Stands right around that right volleyball line. Now he's going to drive into the corner. Thomas crossover now goes left. Kicks to Kobe Jamison, top of the key. Jamison to Bobo, left wing. About 16 seconds on the shot clock. They go to Jamison. Jamison pull up three is good. Raiders retake the lead. Jamison playing off the ball defense. Makes a good play for the Raiders. Everett goes out of bounds. Last touch by Jamison. Makes it 28-25. 2:45 remaining here in the second quarter. Number 13, Ballou with it. Ballou is set to inbound. He inbounds into Jamison. Jamison to Jamari Thomas. Thomas to Taylor Smith. Smith, spot up three in the corner. Just a little off. Rebound goes to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun to Brittingham. Brittingham to Ballou. Ballou takes a bump, loses the grip, and he's going to be called with a traveling violation. 2:29 remaining here in the second quarter. Make sure you do join us for our Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Hopefully we'll have Coach Frisbee up here after a big girls win. He'll be a fun guest to have. Jamari Thomas on a drive. Fade away. They're going to call him with a travel. Referee down here really likes travel. That's two in a row on this. Off the change of possessions, off the first one. 2:22 remaining in the second. Ballou bringing it down the court. Ballou picked up by Jamari Thomas. Ballou's going to go left side. Crosses over, gets his pocket pick. Jamari Thomas on a fast break. Throws a lob. Taylor Smith gets fouled. I mean, it would have been a poster riser if he got the dunk. Fouls going to be charged against number 22, Caden Calhoun. Taylor Smith was going to throw it down. I mean, I'll be honest. I saw it up here. I was excited. I got riled up. And Taylor Smith gets fouled to go to the line to shoot two. That's Calhoun's second team foul, number two as well. At the line shooting is number zero, Taylor Smith. Smith's first one no good. Probably a little shaken up. He hit the ground pretty hard. And coming down from about 10 feet in the air for it, that's his highest reach. Taylor Smith's second one is good, however, 29-25. Taylor Smith probably could jump about 30 inches. He's an outstanding athlete. Number 10, Shipman with the ball. Raiders up by four. 2 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Number 40, Brittingham with it. He goes back door, stolen by the Raiders. Number zero, Taylor Smith. Fast break goes to Jamison. Jamison clear for takeoff, off two, and does not rim. We're having a technical foul. Jamison hung on too long. Kind of popped the rim. Be a technical against Kobe Jamison. That's his first personal and team foul number two. 1:50 remaining here in the second quarter. Taking the technical shots, Jesse Ballou. Outstanding shooter for these Paragould Rams. His first one up, his first one's good. Makes it 29-26. Sub into the game is Brandon Alexander. He's coming in for number 22, Jamison. And after Jamison got teed up, I mean, I don't think it was intentional from Jamison popping the rim like he did. He's just trying to wait for the ground to clear out because he doesn't want to land on somebody, get him hurt or them hurt. Ballou's second one is good. Makes it 29-27. Raiders up by two. Paragould, however, gets the ball back. Paragould brings in a couple subs. They bring back in Dilport and back in number four, Lucas Deatherage. Inbound into number 32. That's Dilport. Dilport's going to go left with it. Going to hesitate. Going to go left. Hands it off to Cole Chipman. Chipman gets a screen. Goes to number 4, Deatherage. Deatherage back to Chipman. Chipman at the top of the key. Skips to Ballou. Ballou drives right side. He's going to get fouled. And fouls going to be charged. See the indication. Number 14, Jamari Thomas. That's Jamari's first personal team foul. Number 3 with 1:34 remaining here in the second quarter. About a minute 34 away from our Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Coach Chipman gets inbound in, and he's going to get the and one. They're going to call it against Brandon Alexander. That's the fourth team foul. Alexander's first personal. Alexander, he's trying to break it down, trying to get down there to Chipman before he can get the layup off. Chipman's free throw up. No good. Rebound to number zero, Taylor Smith. Smith's going to bring it down the court. A slow jog. Going to go right side with it. Couple between the leg moves. Kicks out to Cam Bobo. Bobo left side now moves to the top of the wing. Gets it to number 14, Jamari Thomas in the corner. Thomas going to drive. Kicks to Taylor Smith. Now over to Cam Bobo. Bobo spot up three. No good. Rebound number 32, Dilport. Dilport kicks out to Ballou. Cam Bobo makes an athletic play over there on the sideline. Tips it away. Good job, Cam Bobo, trying to kill that Paragould momentum. Number 13, Ballou inbounds into Dilport. Dilport's going to go right with it. He's going to go down to the corner, hands it off to Chipman. Chipman picked up by Brandon Alexander. Chipman's going to drive, kicks out to Ballou. Ballou could not gain it in. It's going to be Raider ball. 57.9 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. We're all tied up here at 29. Brandon Alexander bringing the ball down the court. Alexander just walking it down. Very slow pace. Cross the timeline at 26 seconds. Going to go over to the left side. Drives. Kicks out to Taylor Smith. Smith, a couple of jab steps. Now he's going to drive. A floater up. Floater no good. Rebound Brandon Alexander. They go inside to Taylor Smith. Smith to Cam Bobo. Bobo shot fake. Drives. A Euro step variation. They miss a shot. Rebound goes to the Raiders. Jamari Thomas, three-point shot, no good. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by Perry will be Raider ball. A very long possession from the Raiders right there. It killed the shot clock. We hit down to 22.4 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Make sure you do stick around for our halftime show. Halftime is presented by Cavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Cavanaugh's entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. Bubba is set to inbound. Raiders use the old elevator screens. They get it to Thomas. Thomas to Brandon Alexander. Raiders playing for the last shot. Brandon Alexander is going to dribble around up there at the volleyball line. Coach Luke Tate tells him to hold it down. He starts to go 10 seconds on the clock. Makes a couple of dribbles. He's going to go left. He's going to drive to the rack. Brandon Alexander makes his layup. Gets 2 points off of it. That's going to end the first half 31 to 29. Raiders up by two. That's the first half for you. We're going to take a quick 3-minute break and come back. We're going to have the Cavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Let's cut that down to 2 minutes. As you remember, Coach Frisbee's on his way up. We're going to take a 2-minute break and come back. We're going to have our halftime show. Halftime is presented by the Cavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Cavanaugh's entire selection, new and pre-owned inventory at CavanaughCars.com. Be back in 2 minutes on the EAB Sports Network.
Huge savings now at every Cavanaugh dealership. Cavanaugh has a great selection of late model, low mileage, certified pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. And most are still under factory warranty. We have every make and every model, so you're sure to find the vehicle you want. And when you buy at Cavanaugh, every new and used purchase comes with 1 year of free maintenance. Plus, we buy cars.
Bring a vehicle?
Get a check. Come see us today at one of our dealerships or go to CavanaughCars.com.
Enjoy no hassles and no hidden fees when you sign up for a free checking account at First Community Bank. Our free checking account comes with the great features you've come to enjoy and expect, such as bill pay, no minimum balance, no monthly service charge, and no paper statement fees. You can also monitor your checking account through our online banking. Enjoy convenient, worry-free checking and friendly, helpful service from First Community Bank, where community comes first. Member FDIC. Minimum $50 to open account. Checking accounts without activity may be charged dormant account fees.
This is Keith Baird with Baird Auto Group. There's nothing that brings our communities together like high school sports. No matter what the scoreboard says, it's a winning feeling just to be a part of it. At Baird, we want you to have the feeling anytime you come into one of our dealerships. Good credit, bad credit, no problem. Don't buy anywhere else until you shop at Baird location near you. Don't get a bad deal, get a Baird deal. Because why pay more?
Saving service, great selection too. Baird does it all for you.
You're listening to the Nettleton Raiders on Bob FM, 101.3 KIYS HD2 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, KIYS HD2, K231 BB College City Jonesboro, KIYS HD4 Walnut Ridge Jonesboro, and KIYS HD4 K267AS Piggott.
I'd like to welcome you into the Cavanaugh Auto Group Halftime Show. We're joined in the NEA Baptist broadcast position with Coach Kevin Frisbee. Coach, good game.
Thank you, man. It was sloppy, but we won. We'll take it.
Might have not have been the results you wanted down there, but you came out with more points than the other team, and that's what matters.
You're right. That's the goal.
Yes, sir.
It's always the goal.
Yeah, Lady Raiders, they were led today by, Donna Douglas. Douglas had 12 points. Talk a little bit how you scored tonight.
Yeah, you know, first time we played them, they played us man for about maybe a quarter or so, and then they went straight 2-3 zone the rest of the game. So we really expected more zone, but they just came out, played man the whole game, so we just tried to run our sets. And honestly, I was proud of – we executed our stuff well. We just missed a lot of stuff early. But, you know, again, anytime we see man, like I've said before, the plan is to get the ball inside. Juice and Donna. Juice has been sick. She was sick all weekend, and she was throwing up at halftime and throwing up in the third quarter. So, you know, she wasn't her normal self tonight, but she still gutted it out and helped us early, scored 9 points. I think all those in the first half, so – a sick Juice is still a good option to have.
Oh, yes, sir. A sick juice tends to be a good score no matter how you look at it.
Yeah.
She's one of your post players, and you like to go to the post.
Yep. Yeah, they're just man-to-man, they're just such a hard matchup for people because they're just so strong, you know, and it's so rare that we see that now. I mean, I think West Memphis played a little bit of man, Marion played straight man, and Pigler straight man. Outside of those three teams, we haven't seen man-to-man in 2 months, you know what I mean? So when we see that, then that's the game plan switches to immediately, let's get the ball inside.
Yes, sir. And we talked a little bit about offense. What's your defensive game plan tonight?
Yeah, I mean, we wanted to pressure the ball. I don't think we did a good job of that at all early. I thought we were too – I thought we played off the basketball too much, and I thought it allowed them to run their stuff kind of how they wanted. And they wanted to run long possessions, shorter – you know, they want to run long possessions to give us fewer possessions. And I thought the first time we played them, our pressure was really, really good, forced a ton of turnovers. And tonight, I didn't think we came out with that same fire. I thought we were flat, to be honest, Jacob. I thought our energy was too low. You know, part of that may be sickness, part of that may be trying to overlook a team that you beat by a lot the first time. But, you know, we didn't play with enough energy on that end, in my opinion.
And sometimes teams will go into games after a big win. I mean, you beat them 42 by, I think, the 42
right.
first time, and they
yeah.
count their chickens before they hatch.
Yes.
That's not something you could do here in the 5A East. That's
exactly
a dog
right.
fight of the conference.
Exactly right.
And talking about a team you kind of whooped the first time, Batesville Pioneers, that's who you have Friday. Big
yes.
big game, senior night.
Huge game. You know, and the first thing we talked about after Paragould in the locker room was we cannot overlook Batesville because they're playing confident. They played Green County Tech to 5 points of the night. They almost beat Marion tonight. They ended up losing to Marion by four, but they were in control of that game. So they're playing well. They're young, and they're scrappy, and they're just getting more confidence every game. You know, as they adjust to the 5A East. But yeah, it's a massive game. Everything is huge from now on. If we win out, we're in the tournament. We could afford to lose one if we get some help from somebody else, but we don't want to, you know, rely on help. We just got to keep winning.
Yes, sir. Winning alone is always good for the Raiders. I mean, going out in a positive record, that's always fun.
Oh, yeah.
And trying to match the boys right now, two very good teams we have at Nettleton.
Yeah, man. Oh, it's fun, man. And it's, you know, Nettleton's been good for a long time, and we've had a lot of really good players and good coaches, and you know what's fun is I feel like I've been at places before where it feels like the boys and the girls programs aren't as connected, and I don't feel that at all here. I think Coach Deaton does a great job of that here, and Coach Tate stepped in and carried that, and I think the players root for each other, which is big, and the coaches are all tight and good friends, and that makes it a lot more fun.
Yes, sir. Talking about good friends with coaches, you and Coach Tate played basketball together.
Yeah.
We talk about that often.
We should.
I mean, back in your day, what was your go-to move?
Well, with him guarding me?
I mean, probably anything, right?
Take your pick. I mean, what do you want? You want a jab pull-up? You want a slow, hezzy, get by him? You want a crossover, double cross? Whatever you want. You know, and listen, I do want to say, you know, I always have to end this with Coach Tate's a good player. Coach Tate was a good teammate, all that stuff. But I'm going to be honest with you. You know, I heard the interview with him. He gave me some respect, but he also – I'm just stuck on this quote from him of he knows I can lock him up.
He did say that. I do recall that, yeah.
Well, I'm going to be honest with you. That replays in my head daily, okay? And I let him know about it. And again, thanks for saying I'm a good player and all that kind of stuff, but you should have ended there, all right? Don't say that you're going to come out here and clamp me up, lock me up, because it's false. Okay, it's absolutely false. And I hope you bring that up to him.
I will. Rounding out your conference play,
yeah.
you're playing two teams you beat by
yeah.
probably 15 or more, I think.
Yeah.
And then that last game, Searcy, that's huge for y'all.
Yes.
You're at Searcy, the new gym.
Yeah.
I haven't been yet. Is it nice?
Very nice.
Okay. So
it's top notch.
We're going to take your word for it. I mean, nothing beats Raider Gym in this great environment here at Raider Gym.
Amen.
But going down to Searcy. Searcy's a team, I really wanted to talk about this. I was hoping we pulled that game off, but that third quarter, you held them scoreless. What was that
yeah.
game plan?
You know, the game plan, it's always to hold them scoreless, Jacob. That's always the plan. If it worked out that way every time, we would be extremely good. Jacob, you're making a mistake here. You're overlooking Batesville and Valley View, and you're jumping ahead to Searcy. If my players do that, we're in trouble, Jacob.
Well, you can think I'm not your players. I'm just the play-by-play guy.
That's true. No, listen, we started off that game horrible. We didn't stick to the game plan at all, and they knew that. Came out second half with a ton of energy. Man, I think if we got two more minutes in that game, we'd probably win that game.
I agree,
but
Coach.
We know them well, man. They know us well. There's not going to be any surprises. The bottom line is we have to play good for four quarters. That's a cliche thing, but that is literally us right now. Like, we're good for a half. We're good for three quarters. And then sometimes, you know, Marion at home, we're good for four quarters. And when we are, we're pretty dang tough. But we can't – I mean, on the road against Searcy in a potential must-win game to keep your season going – it's going to, you know, I think the players are going to be locked in. They're going to have to be. I think at this point, we respect the heck out of them. We need to if we don't, because they're a really good team. And so, I think we'll be ready. And as I've said before, it's going to be a dogfight with them every time we play.
Yes, sir. That's how all these 5A East games go, dogfights after dogfights.
Yes,
Coach,
sir.
I'm glad you came up here and joined us for our Kavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Congratulations.
Thank you,
we'll
man.
Catch you again Friday night.
Get some sleep.
Yes, sir. That was Coach Kevin Frisbee joining us in our Kavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. Halftime is presented by the Kavanaugh Auto Group. Check out Kavanaugh's complete and entire selection of new and pre-owned inventory at KavanaughCars.com. Kind of ran right into the third quarter. We're fixing to get third quarter action started. There's the buzzer if you can hear through the headset. We're excited to bring you the third quarter. Thank you to Coach Kevin Frisbee for joining us in the Kavanaugh Auto Group halftime show. I have to let Coach Tate know that he said that he could do any move on Coach Tate when he comes up for the Barnes Post game show. Raiders up by two right now, 31-29. We're here at home. Raiders will get the ball first. They're going to get it number 22, Kobe Jamison. Jamison to number 3, Brandon Alexander. Alexander's going to bring it down the court. He's going to go to number 30, Deshaun Jackson. Jackson at the free throw line, hands it off to Thomas. Thomas pulls up from the free throw line. No good. Rebound, Cole Chipman. Chipman gets his pass off to Jesse Ballou. Blue going to drive it down the court, kicks to Zachary Fields. Fields to Chipman. Chipman to Nate Brittingham. Brittingham back to Blue. Over to Fields, left side. Now to Chipman in the corner. He drives up, kicks to Brittingham. Brittingham drives, kicks to Caden Calhoun. Calhoun hesitates, misses first shot. Second one up, misses that one at two. Gets his third rebound, gets that one. Makes it 31-31. Paragord brings in Jesse Blue to start the second half. Jesse didn't start tonight. Very interesting call for the Rams. Number 3, Alexander, goes number 22. That's Jamison. Jamison to Thomas. Thomas to Taylor Smith. Smith's going to drive a Euro step floater. No good. Rebound, Deshaun Jackson. Jackson gets it up off of 2, 35-31. Number 5, Fields with the ball. Fields going to hand it off to Jesse Ballou. Ballou drives the baseline, gets fouled. Fouls me again. It's number 14, Jamari Thomas. His second personal team foul, number 1. 6:48 remaining here in the third quarter. Number 5. That's Zach Fields is set to inbound. Fields inbounds into Ballou. Ballou's shot fake goes around Smith, and they're going to say he is fouled. Taylor really confused. I'm not sure if he really agrees with the call. They're going to say he got his arm. It'll be a foul against Smith. Jesse Ballou go to the line to shoot 2. That's Taylor's second personal, second team foul. Ballou's first one up. First one is no good. Rebound goes to nobody. He has 2 more. 33-31, 6:45 remaining here in the third quarter. Ballou's second one up. Second one is good. Makes it 33-32. Raiders here at home. A very dense home crowd. Number 13, Ballou makes the second one. Senior night is the main outlook of this week. Raiders and Batesville. However, we got to get through Paragord first. Number 3, Alexander, over to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson hands it off to Jamison. Jamison in the corner. We have an off-the-ball foul. Deshaun Jackson kind of got mauled down there. Almost a football play from Caden Calhoun. He is a football player. That's Caden Calhoun's third personal team foul, number 1. 6:30 remaining here in the third quarter. Jamari Thomas is set to inbound. He goes to B3. Brandon Alexander. Alexander is going to drive right on the right wing. Now coming back to the top of the key. He hop steps. They're going to call him on a travel. I think it was a hop step, and they caught him. I guess he never set a pivot foot, and they're going to get him on his pivot. Ballou goes to Fields. Fields back to Jesse Ballou. Ballou down to Nate Brittingham. Brittingham, he drives the baseline. He kicks out to number five, Zach Fields. Fields with the ball, skips it back to Brittingham in the corner, on the wing. He drives it. They're going to call a blocking foul, and it's going to send Brittingham to the line to shoot two. They're called against Brandon Alexander. Raider faithful, not too happy with that call. He set his feet, and they're going to call it on the shot. Didn't think he was shooting either. However, he's going to be at the line shooting two. He's shooting now, however. First shot up. First shot is good. Got the Paragold Ram bounce. Kind of rolled around. Finally fell in. 33-34 is the score. Raiders down by one. Brittingham second shot up. Second shot is good. Makes it 33-35. Jamari Thomas with the ball off the inbound. He's going to jog it down the court fast pace. Thomas hesitation. He's going to drive left side. Goes to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson fills his man. Turns around and one. Count the basket. Deshaun to go to the line to shoot two. Foul against Caden Calhoun, his fourth personal, team foul number two. At the line shooting end one is number 30, Deshaun Jackson, the 6'7 senior for the Nettleton Raiders. Deshaun, he's a man among boys walking around the hallways. He's always been a guy I looked up to. He's always been a lot taller than me. Deshaun Jackson's first one up, only one up, it's good. Makes it 36-35. 5:50 remaining here in the third. Shipman over to Dilport. Dilport, that's Eccles. Eccles to Ballou. Ballou's layup missed. Raiders on a fast break. Jamison has a one-on-two. Jamison, left-hand layup is good. Makes it 38-35. Number five, Fields, goes to Shipman. Shipman, he's driving left side, bounces it to Eccles. Eccles' layup is up. Eccles' layup is good. 38-37, Raiders, they're up by one. 5:20 remaining here in the third quarter. Number three, Brandon Alexander with the ball. Alexander kicks out to Jamari Thomas. Thomas goes back to Alexander in the corner. He's going to drive. Kicks out to Jamison. Jamison jab step, drives, kicks to Alexander. Alexander, three-point shot, no good. Rebound, Jamison. Jamison cleans it up, makes it 40-37. Jesse Ballou spins around a trap, drives. Layup up, layup no good. Rebound, Eccles. Eccles gets the nod. Chipman off the rebound. His shot up, shot no good. Rebound, Jamison. Jamison's pass is intercepted by Ballou. Ballou got his pass intercepted. Taylor Smith down court. Floater up, floater no good. Rebound to number 23, Eccles. Eccles to Fields, and we're going to have a timeout on the floor. Timeout Paragold. 4:36 remaining here in the third quarter, 40-37. I believe it's going to be a full timeout. We're going to take it with them back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
When this is the sound of a waterfall in nature, there's no cause for concern. But when it's the sound of water gushing through your living room ceiling because a pipe burst inside the wall, there's reason to panic, unless you pick up the phone and call 1-800-SERV-PRO. Only the cleanup and restoration specialists at ServPro can help make fire and water damage like it never even happened. So make the call to 1-800-SERV-PRO at the first sign of water damage. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
Or call me, David Ellison, at 870-897-7888 or 870-934-0501 for your next fire or water cleanup.
Nettleton High School Athletics is brought to you by Gateway Tire and Service Center and Toyo Tires, where there's always one thing you can count on. We go the distance for you. Before you hit the road for a trip across country or across town, drop by Gateway Tire and Service Center and check out the great deals on Toyo Tires. Whether it's tire or auto repair, you can always count on one thing. At Gateway Tire and Toyo Tires, we go the distance for you. At Gateway Tire in Jonesboro, we go the distance for you.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM. Number five, Zachary Fields for Paragold with the ball. Paragold over to Jesse Ballou. Ballou right side goes to number 40, Brittingham. Hey, Brittingham over number five, Fields. Fields to number 23, Eccles. He goes to Dilport. Dilport to Ballou. Ballou right wing, drives the baseline. Floater up, fade away. No good. Rebound, number 22, Kobe Jamison. Jamison's going to run the fast break. Going to slow jock it down. Kicks to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson is going to call him on a charge. They're going to Say number 32, Dilport got down there, set his feet, and Deshaun Jackson's going to pick up a charge. His first personal team foul, number 4. Number 5, Fields to Brittingham. Brittingham, it gets trapped. They're going to say he's bumped the opposite side ref. The ref closest to him didn't make the call. It's the one on the far side. Going to get number 14, Jamari Thomas, with his third personal team foul, number 5. Raiders going to have a sub waiting. That's team foul number 5. Going to send Brittingham to the line to shoot 2. Raiders have enough fouls to put Paragon in the bonus. Brittingham at the line. Misses his first one, goes right off the front iron. No good. 4:03 remaining here in the third quarter. Cam Bobo joins the Raiders on the court. He's coming in for Jamari Thomas. Brittingham's second one is good. Makes it 40-38. Raiders up by 2. Taylor Smith dribbling it down the court. Goes to B3. Brandon Alexander. Alexander going to drive right side. Comes back left. He goes to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson goes to Jamison. Jamison, excellent pass and score. Makes it 42-38. Raiders up by 4. Number 5, Fields over to Ballou. Ballou out to Brittingham. Brittingham with the ball. Going to drive over. Back to Ballou. Ballou kicks out. Number 5, Fields. Fields to Dilport. Dilport spot up 3. No good. Rebound. Number 0, Taylor Smith. Taylor's going to drive it down the court. Hesitation moves. Going to drive the baseline now. Pull up floater. He's fouled to go to the line to shoot 2. And called against number 5, Zach Fields. I believe that's going to be his first personal team foul, number 3. At the line, shooting 2 is number 0, Taylor Smith. Smith is at the line. He does his free throw routine. His first one up. First one is good. 3:23 remaining here in the third quarter. 43-38. Raiders up by 5. At the line, shooting his second one is Taylor Smith. Smith gets the ball, does his free throw routine. Shot up. Shot is good. Makes it 44-38. Raiders up by 6. 3:20 remaining here in the third quarter. Fields back to Ballou, and Ballou just could not reach it. Goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paragord. Now 3:18 remaining here in the third quarter. Not much time was ran off the clock. Taylor is set to inbound. Taylor Smith, that is. He's waiting to get the ball. Taylor is getting the ball now. Slaps it, sets up the play. He goes to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson to B3. Brandon Alexander. Alexander into Jackson. Now to number 12, Cam Bobo. Bobo for 3. No good. Number 0, Taylor Smith. It's going to be foul. Foul on the floor. Foul charge against number 40. That's Nate Brittingham. That's his first personal team foul, number 4. Back into the game for the Raiders. Number 4, Q Thompson. He's coming in for B3, Brandon Alexander. Number 12, Cam Bobo is set to inbound. He inbounds into Deshaun Jackson. Jackson to Jamison. This is going to drive. Kicks out to number 0, Taylor Smith. Smith going to drive right. Euro step. Kicks to Jackson. Jackson turns around, lays it in with the right hand. Jackson has 10 points on the night. Number 5, Fields with the ball. Fields drives right. Kicks to number 32, Dilport. Dilport to Brittingham. Brittingham throws it off of Jackson. However, he regains it. Number 5, Fields off the drive. Kicks to Dilport. Dilport to Ballou. Ballou got the ball behind him. Loses the grip. Kicks out to Fields. Fields with the ball over to Dilport to Ballou in the corner. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Brittingham drives. They're going to call a foul and be a defensive foul against number 4, Q Thompson. I believe that's going to be Q's number first personal team foul, number 6, so it's going to send Brittingham to the line to shoot 2. At the line, shooting 2, number 40, Nate Brittingham. Brittingham's first one up. First one is no good. Heard a screech in Raider Gym. Somebody did not want him to make that free throw. 2:29 remaining here in the third quarter. Brittingham shot up. Shot is good. 46-39. Raiders, they're up by 7. Number 12, Cam Bobo with the ball. Bobo over to Q Thompson. Thompson right wing. He's going to go left. Picks up his dribble. Goes to Cam Bobo. Bobo left wing. Goes inside to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson out to Jamison. Jamison now to Cam Bobo. Bobo shot fake. He's going to drive. Pulls up from about 12. Doesn't get it to fall. Going to have a foul against Q Thompson. Thompson trying to engage a jump ball. Be his second personal team foul. Number 7 is going to send Jesse Ballou to the line to shoot 2. Coach Tate thought it'd be a jump ball. Fuck you did a good job of getting down there, making a hustle play, trying to force the old jump ball. However, the referee disagrees with my eyes. He is more knowledgeable in the game. Balu's first one up. First one, I think that fell. It had a light net movement. It did fall. It makes it 46-40. Very eloquent ball movement by Balu. That second one is good. Makes a big splash. 46-41. Raiders still up by five. 2 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. 2 minutes remaining. Number 12, Bobo with the ball. Bobo goes left, hands it off to Taylor Smith. Smith drives, kicks to Jackson. Jackson, one dribble, tried to dunk it. However, Taylor Smith off the rebound, gets fouled. I'll go to the line to shoot two. Foul is going to be charged against Paragould's number 32, Caden Dilport. I believe that's going to be his first personal team foul, number five. The Raiders are in the bonus as well, so every foul for the next minute 50 in the third. Be at the line shooting two. Taylor Smith makes his first one. He has 14 points on the night, 47-41. Raiders have the six-point advantage. Number zero, Taylor Smith, misses his second one. Rebound goes to number 23, Echols. Echols to Balu. Balu's pass almost intercepted. Now the ball is intercepted. Q Thompson out to Taylor Smith. Smith to the rack. It gets mauled. Number five, Zachary Fields. I guess he really just did not want to get dunked on. Number five, Fields picks up his second personal team foul. Number six, missing Taylor Smith to the line to shoot another two. Foul charged against Zach Fields. Taylor Smith at the line shooting. 1:39 remaining in the third. Smith makes his first one, makes it 48-41. Raiders up by seven. Into the game for the Raiders, number 32, A.D. Blackburn. He's going in for Deshaun Jackson at the line shooting his second one. It's number zero, Taylor Smith. Smith misses it as well. Rebound goes to Echols. Echols to Blue. Blue out to Chipman. Chipman gets trapped. They go back to Balu. Balu's going to drive. Going to go right to the rack. They say it's blocked out of bounds by A.D. Blackburn. Be Paragould ball. 48-41. Raiders up by 7. 1:27 remaining here in the third quarter. Number 32. That's Dilport set to inbound. He goes to Balu. Balu going to drive. Goes up. They're going to call a foul. See who they're going to call it against. Two men down there. They're going to call it against number 32, A.D. Blackburn. His first personal team foul, number seven. At the line shooting is number 13. That's Jesse Balu. Foul against A.D. Blackburn. That's why I was thinking A.D. Jesse misses his first one. With 1:24 remaining here in the third, 48-41 is the score. Raiders up by seven. Balu's second one is good. Makes it 48-42. Raiders up by six. Taylor Smith bringing it down the court. Taylor setting up the Raider offense. He's going to go left side, crosses over, kicks out to Q Thompson. Thompson pulls up from about 10. His shot no good. However, Kobe Jamison cleans it up. He has 15 points on the night. 50-42. Jesse Balu with the ball beats the Raider press. Balu's going to drive the baseline. Euro step no good. Rebound to Paragould. They're going to throw it off of number 32, A.D. Blackburn. And it's going to be Paragould with the ball. 55 seconds remaining here in the third. Make sure you do stick around for fourth quarter to follow. Number 13, Jesse Balu with the ball. He goes over number 10, Chipman. Chipman. Number 32, that's Dilport to Brenningham in the corner. They skip out to Balu. Balu pull up three, sinks it. What a shot from Jesse Balu. 50-45, Raiders up by five. 35 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Shot clock and game clock, about a six-minute margin. Bobo on a drive, kicks to Blackburn. Blackburn misses his layup. Rebound Paragould, 27 seconds on the clock. They get it down to Brenningham. Brenningham kicks out to number 32, Dilport. Dilport to number 13, Jesse Balu. It's a five-point margin. Raiders up by five, 50-45. Chipman over to number 32. That's Dilport. Got 9 seconds on the clock. Dilport now driving left, goes to Balu. Balu back to Dilport. Dilport right wing, kicks out. Q Thompson steals it, and that's going to end the third quarter. Q tried to heave it, did not have enough air on it. That's going to end our third quarter. 50-45, Raiders up by five. Be back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
having trouble getting the trailer you need? Silver Line Trailers, the largest trailer retailer in the USA, has the perfect solution for you. Guaranteed approval. No credit check required. Get the quality trailer you need at a price you can afford. With over 3,500 trailers available and more coming in daily, we'll find the perfect trailer for you. And at Silver Line, we're always looking to hire good people. Visit our website, silverlinetrailer.com, for a location near you. You can stop by our Jonesboro location today at 3711 Stadium Boulevard or call 870-203-0000. Silver Line Trailers, your trusted trailer retailer.
Mom, I can't get my homework to upload.
Dad, my video game is froze again.
Babe, is our internet down again? I'm missing the big game.
Honey, I'm trying to make this online payment, but it just keeps buffering.
Get your life up to speed with high-speed internet from Empower Broadband. Empower's reliable service brings high-speed internet to even the most remote areas of Northeast Arkansas. With Empower Broadband, you can stream your favorite movies, video chat with loved ones, work from home without interruptions, and so much more. Empower Broadband. Life up to speed. For more info, visit empowerbroadband.com.
Raider Nation here in the fourth quarter. Raider is up by five. Soulja Boy Crank That is playing a song. Blake Isbell is very fond, too. Blake is a member of the NTV crew tonight. Paragold starts off with the ball. He's going to go out of bounds. Be last touch by Taylor Smith. Smith did a good job deflecting it out. Good off-the-ball pressure from number zero, Taylor Smith. Number 13, Ballou is set to inbound. Raiders applying a full-court press. They're going to inbound into number 32, Dilport. Dilport goes back to Ballou. Ballou's guarded by Taylor Smith, full court. Ballou's going to go right side with it. He kicks out to Brittingham. Brittingham at the elbow. They go back to Jesse Ballou. Ballou's shot fakes. He's going to get a screen, go left. Kicks out to Brittingham. Brittingham to number 32. That's a Dilport back to Ballou. Ballou top of the key, drives the rack. Ball deflected. Ballou comes away with it. They kick back to Brittingham. Brittingham at the elbow. Tries to go inside number 23, Echo. It's going to be Raider ball. Sub into the game for Paragold. Number 22, Caden Calhoun. Number 5, Zach Fields. Fields is coming in for Dilport and Calhoun in for Echols. Number 3, Brandon Alexander is going to bring it up the court. Alexander, the 5'7 senior for this Raider team, is going to go left, go to Jamari Thomas on the wing. Thomas, he picks up his dribble, goes to Deshaun Jackson, top of the key. Jackson to Alexander. Alexander working his post move, gets it to Jackson. Jackson gets his score, 52-45, Raiders up by 7. Jesse Ballou with the ball. Ballou is going to drive left, beats the press solely, going to the rack. They're going to up and under and one, makes it 52-47. They're going to call it against Deshaun Jackson, his second personal team foul, number one. He makes it the first team foul of the quarter. Jesse Ballou's shot up. Shot is good. Makes it 52-48. Raiders still up by four. 6:55 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Brent Alexander is going to slowly walk it up the court. Alexander now goes right side to Taylor Smith on the wing. Taylor's going to drive left. Goes to Brent Alexander in the corner. Alexander gets his shot blocked. However, he gets his own putback. Gives that to Jamari Thomas. Thomas going to drive. His floater up. Floater no good. Rebound, Caden Calhoun. They get it to Cole Chipman. Chipman down to Brittingham. He's going to drive. Brittingham up and under. A little reverse layup. No good. Rebound, Raiders. Number 22, Jamison to Jamari Thomas. Thomas setting up the offense. Slows it down. Kicks to number 3, Brandon Alexander. Alexander above the volleyball line. He's getting his play call. The Raiders are running a little motion. They get it to number 22. Jamison pulls up about the free throw line, doesn't get it to fall. Chipman with the defensive rebound. He kicks down to Ballou. Ballou on the corner, loses the handle on it. Kicks out to number 5, Fields. Fields to Brittingham. We have a timeout, Paragold. It's at 5:55 remaining here in the 4:52-48. It's going to be a full timeout. Back in 60 on the EAB Sports Network.
Is your HVAC system ready for fall and winter? Find out today with the Moore Super Checkup. Prevent unexpected breakdowns while extending the life of your system. Whether you need a heating or cooling inspection, we cover it all for just $55 for 55 years serving you. Call Moore Air Conditioning today, 870-260-7030, or visit us at moreac.com. Don't settle for less.
You deserve more. Don't settle for less.
love your truck, and Plaza Tire Service is here to help you make it even better. We've got wheels, leveling kits, and of course, the area's largest selection of light truck tires. With ATs and mud tires up to 35s and bigger, Plaza Tire Service has you covered. The pros at Plaza Tire Service can help you select a great combination that will work with your truck. Plus, with our Plaza Tire Service card or no credit needed financing, your upgrades can be easy on your budget. So take your truck from stock to spectacular with Plaza Tire Service.
Yeah. Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM. Raiders up by 4, 52-48 is the score. 5:55 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Paragol's going to have the ball coming out of the timeout. They called it on offense, 27 seconds remaining on the shot clock. They inbound into Brittingham. Brittingham picks up his dribble, kicks out to Cole Chipman on the left wing. He's going to drive, kicks to Fields. Fields driving left, goes to Brittingham. Brittingham with it. He's driving, picks up his dribble on his drive, kicks to Calhoun. Now low. Calhoun on a little bit of a fadeaway, no good. Rebound, Taylor Smith. They were going to play the point guard, get it down the court. He goes left side with it, crossover. Now going right, he going to the rack. Missed his layup, however, Deshaun Jackson picks it up, gets fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Foul against number 22, Caden Calhoun, his fifth personal. And team foul number one. That's all we'll see out of Mr. Calhoun on the night. His five personals. And at the line shooting two is number 30, Deshaun Jackson. 5:27 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Number 30, Deshaun Jackson's first one is nothing but nylon. Makes it 53-48. 5:27 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Make sure you stick around for the Barton's postgame show. Build it better with Barton's. Jackson, second one up. Second one, no good. Rebound, number 22, Jamison. Jamison's put back, no good. Lose the ball. They're going to say it's going Paragold way. Coach Tate not very happy with it. However, it's going to be Paragold with the possession. 5:22 remaining here in the fourth quarter, 53-48. Raiders, they're up by five. Number five, Zach Fields hands it off to Brittingham. Brittingham drives, kicks to Echols, now to Fields. Fields to Chipman, top of the key. Hits a cutting blue, ever stolen by Jamari Thomas. Thomas, excellent off the ball play. Gets the ball for the Raiders. Number 14, Thomas, he's going to pull back his drive, kicks to number three, Brandon Alexander. Alexander to Jamison. Jamison right wing goes inside to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson turns around, sinks his layup. Deshaun Jackson is having a great night for the Raiders. Deshaun has 15 points. Number five, Fields, fast pace, gets it down to Echols. Echols gets the nod. Echols says he got down there. Deshaun Jackson, he said not today to Mr. Echols, and Deshaun just blocked it. 4-4 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Number 10, Chipman with the ball. Chipman goes in to number 5, Fields, and we're going to have an off-the-ball foul on Taylor Smith. Smith's third personal, team foul number 1. 4:36 remaining here in the fourth quarter. It's going to be Paragol ball under their own goal. Number 5, Fields is set to inbound. Fields inbounds in. Number 40, Brittingham. Brittingham turns around, hands it off to Ballou. Ballou's going to drive. He loses the grip. Kobe Jamison on the takeaway. Kobe Jamison going to the rack. Gets fouled to go to the line to shoot two. 4:27 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Foul charge against, I believe, number 40. That's Brittingham. His second personal. Team foul number 2. Timeout Paragold. Timeout Rams. 4:27 remaining here in the fourth quarter. 55-48. Raiders up by 7. We have full timeout. Back in 60 seconds on the EAB Sports Network.
Hello, I'm estate planning and elder law attorney Chad Oldham. More and more often today, I hear clients tell me that the only thing golden about the golden years is that it takes all the gold to grow old. Don't be a victim of rising health care and nursing home costs. Be prepared. Have a plan. Contact us today to find out how we help our clients protect and preserve assets for family and future generations. The Oldham Law Firm, 603 Southwest Drive in Jonesboro, or visit us on the web at oldhamlawfirm.com.
Central Ford in Truman has your vehicle and your back. Call Central Ford today to schedule your service appointment. Central Ford Service Department is even open on Saturdays. Whether you need an oil change, tire rotation, wheel alignment, brake service, battery inspection, or full engine repair, you can count on the service team at Central Ford in Truman. Next time your vehicle needs maintenance, remember Central Ford. Professional, convenient, reliable. Central Ford, exit 29 off I-555 in Truman and online at centralfordtruman.com.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. We're glad you're joining us here on this nice Tuesday night. Weather picked up from where it was yesterday, or at least where I was. I was in Little Rock for the past 2 days for an East event. It was really cold yesterday, really warm today. Number 22, Jamison, is shooting two at the line. Misses his first one, went off the back iron. A little too much on it. Not a typical shot from Jamison at the line. However, his second one is now taking place. His second one up. Second one is good. Raiders extend the lead to 8. 4:27 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Zachary Fields with the ball. He's backing down Taylor Smith as he crosses the timeline. Fields hesitates, goes to the right wing, picks up his dribble, goes inside to Echols. Echols turns around, spins, gets out to number 5, Fields. They go back to Echols. Echols, shot no good. Rebound, Taylor Smith. Smith driving down the lane, kicks out to number 3, Brandon Alexander. Alexander to Jamison. Jamison loses the grip, gets to number 3, Alexander. To Jackson, to Jamison, and the Raiders make the points. However, it got done. And Jamison gets 2. Number 23, Echols with the ball. Echols to Chipman. Chipman driving down. He's going to pull it back out, kicks the blue. Blue drives. They're going to call a foul. I see they're going to call it against. Number 14, Jamari Thomas. Didn't see Thomas apply too much force. That's his fourth personal ever. He found number 3. 3:38 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Ballou's going to be at the line shooting 2. Raiders up by 10. Ballou's first one up. First one off the front iron. And Ballou has a second shot with 3:38 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Make sure you do stick around for that Barden's post-game show. Build it better with Barden. 58-38 is the score. Raiders, they're up by 10. 13, Ballou, second shot up. Second shot is good. Nothing but net. Cuts to the Raider lead down to 9. Brandon Alexander bringing the ball down the court. He's going to walk it down the court. Crosses about 28 seconds on the timeline. He goes, tries to go to Taylor Smith. Ballou does a good job of tipping away. It's going to remain Raider way. And he's going to be Raider ball. Jason Ballou pointed to himself. He said, I tipped it out. Paraguay was booing the refs, and Ballou took the blame for it. Into the game for Paragold is number 5, Fields. It's coming in for number 13, Ballou. Number 0, Taylor Smith goes to number 3, Brandon Alexander. Alexander's bringing it down the court on a slow walk. Yeah, goes left, goes to number 14, Jamari Thomas. Thomas inside to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson turns around, gets a foul to go to the line to shoot 2. Got fouled in his shooting motion. May not have put a shot all the way up. Number foul charged against number 5, Zach Fields, his third personal. Team foul number 3 at the line shooting is number 30, Deshaun Jackson. His first one is nothing but net. Deshaun makes it. Makes it 59-49. Deshaun has came a long way in free throws this year. He had a couple trips early in the season, missed both of them. This time he makes both of them right here. That brings the Raiders up by 11, 60-49. Number 32, Dilport with the ball. Dilport crosses over. He's going to drive. Right side pulls it back out, kicks at Brittingham. Brittingham over to Fields. Fields playing a little bit faster. He kicks out to Brittingham. Brittingham on a drive, floater up, floater no good. Rebound number 22, Jamison. Jamison down to Thomas. Thomas on a fast break, makes a hesitation move, dribbles it back out. He's going to kick out to Brandon Alexander. Brandon Alexander right wing to Taylor Smith, cutting back door. Smith to Jackson. Jackson, layup is good. Makes it 62-49. Raiders up by 13. Paragold, long range skip pass stolen by Taylor Smith. Here comes the Raiders. Number 3, Brandon Alexander floats it up to Taylor Smith. Should have been an off-the-ball foul in my opinion. However, we're going to have a late call against number 32, Dilport. This is going to be on the floor. We're going to have the Dilbert second personal. However, we're at the line shooting two. That's five team fouls. See who's going to put up. They're going to put at the line. It looks like they knew Brandon Alexander was going to try to throw the lob, and they both of the men came down. They went right to Taylor. They got a little handsy with him during his takeoff. But they're going to put Jamari Thomas at the line shooting. Thomas is doing his shots from the line. We're going to have a timeout, timeout. Paragould, 30-second timeout, and it's their last timeout. They're going to take a with 2:28 remaining here in the fourth quarter. 62-49, Raiders up, back in 30 on the EAB Sports Network.
First Security has been putting our home state first since 1932, helping fellow Arkansans and their families buy homes, grow businesses, and build futures. Today, First Security is still committed to helping you bank better, providing local solutions and local support in the places we love too. It's community banking with people you know and people you know you can count on. First Security. Bank better. FSBank.com. Member FDIC.
Raider basketball here on 101.3 The Bob FM and Nettleton Television. Raiders up by 13, 62-49 is the score with 2:28 remaining here in the first quarter. Make sure you do stick around for the Barton's postgame show. We'll have an interview with Coach Luke Tate. Typically, after the Raiders win, we'll have Tate come up, give a few words. Jamari Thomas makes his first one. Had the Raider bounce, gets a little sink on it. 63-49 is the score. Raiders holding on to that lead. He makes the second one. Looked a lot prettier. However, a made shot, a made shot. Makes both of them. Echols down, Chipman down to Dilport. Dilport picked up by Taylor Smith. He's going to go left, kicks to Fields. Fields guarded by B3, Brandon Alexander. A kick down to Jesse Ballou. Ballou to Echols. Echols, reverse layup falls, makes it 64-51. Raiders up by 13. Number three, Brandon Alexander. B3 bringing it down the court. He's on a slow dribble down. He gets double teamed. They kick to Jamari Thomas. Thomas to number 22, Jamison. Jamison tries to get a layup up through contact. Paragold brings down the rebound. Number 32, Dilport with the ball. Dilport skips it down to Chipman in the left corner. Chipman hands it out to Ballou. Back to Chipman to Fields. Number 32, Dilport. He goes to Chipman. Now to Ballou. Ballou, top of the key, jab step, drives right. They're going to call a charge. Brandon Alexander, very good at it, sets his feet and gets the charge. He picks up a lot of charges throughout the year. That's Ballou's first personal. Offensive foul. Doesn't really, it counts if you're not in the bonus. However, the Raiders are in the bonus. They won't go down and shoot. Number zero, Taylor Smith beats the press. They get it to Deshaun Jackson. Jackson floats it to Kobe Jamison. Jamison to Smith. Down to Deshaun. Deshaun off two. He gets mauled down there. I thought he was going to throw one down. I got a little hyper. I like seeing a big monster jam from the 6'7 senior Deshaun Jackson. They're going to call it against number five, Zach Fields. His fourth personal team foul, number, let's say, around seven. They have a handful on the night. We're 30. Deshaun Jackson's first one at the line. Off the front iron, could not get it to fall. Into the ball game for Paragould is going to be number two. And that is Corbin Bailey and number four, Lucas Dethridge. About 1:25 remaining here in the fourth quarter. At the line, shooting his second one's 30, Deshaun Jackson. His second one is good. Brings the Raider lead to 14. Number 10, Chipman goes down to Dethridge. Dethridge bringing it up the court. He's going to go left side with it. He hands it off to number two. But he tried to hand it off to Bailey. Thomas steals it. They get it to number zero, Taylor Smith. Smith hesitation. Step back. He's going to drive. Taylor Smith gets fouled to go to the line to shoot two. Foul charge to number 32. That's Caden Dilport. His fourth personal team foul. We're calling again Dilport. The announcer said a different name. We had a different. They might have a different roster than I do. And they're going to send number zero, Taylor Smith, to the line to shoot two. Taylor Smith has 15 points on the night. He's third in scoring. Typically, he's either first or second. However, Deshaun Jackson is having a killer game tonight. Deshaun, according to the score book and the score table down low, he has 20 points. Doing the math on mine down up here, trying to get a good estimate on what he has. We have him for 21. Raiders bring in some substitutions. Bring in Braylon Green, Cam Bobo, number 4, Q Thompson, number 32, A.D. Blackburn. Right set, Fred busting heads at the scores table waiting for Taylor Smith. Taylor makes his first one, and in comes right set, Fred busting heads making money. Taylor Smith leaves with 16 points, 67-51. 105 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Lead number 32, Dilport bringing it down the court. He goes over to Corbin Bailey. Bailey down to number 12. That's Lane Holden. Holden back to Bailey. They go back to Holden. Holden down low. Skips it out to Dilport to number 4, Deathridge. Deathridge pull up three is good. Makes it 67-54. Raiders up by 13. About 40 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter. Cam Bobo bringing it down the court. Bobo going to go left side. Bobo cross over a few times. Loses the grip. Dilport on the steal. Dilport on a fast break. Makes his layup. Makes it 67-56. Raiders up by 9. Right set, Fred off the inbound. Crosses over a few times. He's going to drive. Spins around. He goes to A.D. Blackburn. Blackburn could not gain it. And number 2, Bailey with the steal. They go to number 3. Don't have that young man on my roster. I get it down to number 32. That's Dilport, and Dilport go to the line to shoot 2. Foul against number 32, A.D. Blackburn. His second personal team foul, number 4. Sends Dilport to, excuse me, that's not Dilport, that's Holden to the line to shoot 2. I saw 2 and assumed 32. Dilport's, Holden, second one, first one's no good. 7.2 remaining here in the fourth quarter. About 7 seconds away for our Barton's postgame show. Build it better with Barton's. Holden's second one, no good. Rebound Q Thompson. Thompson beats the fast break. Kicks number 2, Braylon Green. Green going to the rack. And the ball gets tipped out by Corbin Bailey, and he's receiving a stand ovation. Paragold fans are enjoying Corbin Bailey's style of play. Raiders inbound it. They win it. Inbound into Fred. Fred pull up 3, and that's going to end the fourth quarter. 67-56, Raiders. They win it by 11 here at Raider Gym. We're going to take a quick 3-minute break. When we come back, we'll have our Barton's postgame show, Build It Better with Barton's. Back in 3 minutes on the EAB Sports Network.
At Barton's, we see your commitment to making your project a success. From the pro up with the son that doesn't quit until it goes down, to the DIYer who faces each challenge head on, our seasoned store partners support you every step of the way. Since 1885, Barton's has been the backbone of local communities for every type of project. From new construction to home remodel, our dedicated team is here to empower your project with local delivery options and a variety of complimentary project services, including expert kitchen planning. Visit your hometown team today and build it better with Barton's. Having trouble getting the trailer you need? Silver Line Trailers, the largest trailer retailer in the USA, has the perfect solution for you. Guaranteed approval, no credit check required. Get the quality trailer you need at a price you can afford. With over 3,500 trailers available and more coming in daily, we'll find the perfect trailer for you. And at Silver Line, we're always looking to hire good people. Visit our website, silverlinetrailer.com, for a location near you. You can stop by our Jonesboro location today at 3711 Stadium Boulevard or call 870-203-0000. Silver Line Trailers, your trusted trailer retailer. It's a mix and match special now at all Northeast Arkansas Domino's Pizza locations. Choose any two for $6.99 each for carryout or delivery. How about a medium two-topping pizza, oven-baked sandwich, pasta and a tin, loaded tots, Domino's stuffed cheesy bread, bread twists, marble brownies, and so much more. Switch it up for lunch or dinner for the whole gang. The mix and match special with any two for only $6.99 each for carryout or delivery. Only at your Northeast Arkansas area Domino's Pizza locations.
NEA Baptist Women's Clinic is now accepting prenatal appointments. Ladies, if you're expecting, get the prenatal care you and baby need and treat yourself to an A-rated delivery experience when you combine the expert team of labor and delivery nurses with the prenatal care in our women's clinic. Call 936-8000 to schedule a prenatal appointment with one of our obstetricians at the NEA Baptist Women's Clinic. Meet the team and learn more at neabaptistclinic.org. NEA Baptist, we put the A in baby.
Enjoy no hassles and no hidden fees when you sign up for a free checking account at First Community Bank. Our free checking account comes with the great features you've come to enjoy and expect, such as bill pay, no minimum balance, no monthly service charge, and no paper statement fees. You can also monitor your checking account through our online banking. Enjoy convenient, worry-free checking and friendly, helpful service from First Community Bank, where community comes first. Member FDIC. Minimum $50 to open account. Checking accounts without activity may be charged dormant account fees.
When this is the sound of a waterfall in nature, there's no cause for concern. But when it's the sound of water gushing through your living room ceiling because a pipe burst inside the wall, there's reason to panic, unless you pick up the phone and call 1-800-SERV-PRO. Only the cleanup and restoration specialists at ServPro can help make fire and water damage like it never even happened. So make the call to 1-800-SERV-PRO at the first sign of water damage. Franchises are independently owned and operated.
Or call me, David Ellison, at 870-897-7888 or 870-934-0501 for your next fire or water cleanup.
I'd like to welcome you into the Barden's post-game show, Build It Better with Barden's. We're glad you're joining us here on the EAB Sports Network, Nettleton TV. However you're joining us, we're glad you did it. And glad the Raiders came away with a sweep. That's always big here at Raider Gym. A sweep, bringing out the brooms. That's always fun. Both teams win tonight. We're going to break down scoring quarter by quarter. Hopefully Coach Luke Tate will come up and join us for the Barden's postgame show. Build It Better with Barden's. Excited to bring you all the action. First quarter, the Raiders had a 6-point lead, 20-14. Raiders leading scorer Taylor Smith came out hot. He scored 10. It's his most dominant quarter of the night for the Paragould Rams. They were led by Jesse Ballou. He had 5 points in an impressive way. He came off the bench shooting and got hot for the Rams. I was interested why they didn't start Ballou tonight. He is a for sure one of Paragould's best players. He is an all-around athlete. Had 19 points on the night. Jesse Ballou had a phenomenal game. For the Raiders in the second quarter, they were outscored by the Rams 11-15. However, going into the halftime, Raiders were up 31-29. And coming out of the half, the Raiders outscored the Rams 19-16. Going into the fourth quarter, 50-45. Leading scorers at the going into that break, Jameson, he had a grand total of 15. Jackson had 11 at third quarter, and Taylor Smith had 15 as well. In the fourth quarter, the Raiders, they were led, charged by Jackson. Jackson really had his breakaway quarter right here in the fourth. He scored 10 points, alternating between hard layups to do. I mean, off two, through contact, and free throws. That's how he scores most of his points all night, either a very finesse layup off two, trying to beat the contact or a free throw at the line. A very improved player. DeSean Jackson, he started the season. He missed a couple of free throws. He went to a couple attempts at the line, missing both of them, and he has adapted to the game. He's making the most of his free throws when he goes to the line. Big shout-out to DeSean Jackson. He's been improvising, adapting, and overcoming at the free throw line all year. Big shout-out to DeSean. For Paragould, in that fourth quarter, they only scored 9 points. Their leading scorer that quarter was, you guessed it, Jesse Ballou. He had 4 points, Deathridge with three, and Caden Calhoun with two. The Raiders' leading scorer on the night was DeSean Jackson. Jackson had 21. Jameson had 18, and Taylor Smith had 17. Typically, you see the Raiders' leading scorers are Taylor Smith and Jameson. However, DeSean Jackson tonight, he had a great game for the Raiders. 21 hard-earned points. Shout out to DeSean Jackson. We're going to go to Neymar Jonesboro Orthopedic Sports Medicine Player of the Game. Player of the Game is brought to you by Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. They've been getting you back in the game for more than 40 years. We're going to give it to DeSean Jackson. DeSean had 21 points on the night. DeSean, a powerful post player. He stands at 6'7". He's a big guy. I mean, I see him in the hallways. He towers amongst everybody at the school. He got a massive dunk down in the first quarter. Him and Taylor both had a dunk of their own. Jameson tried to get one. He hung on the rim, could not make the dunk. Got teed up, an interesting call. However, Jameson had an attempt dunk, and the Raiders come out with the win. Jonesboro Orthopedic Sports Medicine Player of the Game goes to DeSean Jackson. Outstanding game from DeSean. A lot of points down low, a lot of points at the line. Very phenomenal player DeSean is. that's going to wrap up our Barden's postgame show. I thought Coach Tate would come talk to us. He hasn't left the locker room yet. Might be dealing with some important issues. Hope, Coach, everything's good down there from Coach Tate and the Raiders. After a very big win, we got Batesville coming next this Friday. It's Batesville versus the Raiders here at Raider Gym, and it's a very special occasion. The last time the Class of 24 will ever play in the gym. Some may say Class of 24 is the best class ever. People like me who are graduating in the Class of 24 were way better than those old heads from Class of 89. I'll tell anybody that. The Raiders, they're coming here back home for the final game for the Class of 24, and that wraps up our night. The Raiders with a sweep. I'd like to wish everybody a good night. Raider pride is justified. Raider pride forever.
You've been listening to Nettleton Raider Basketball, presented by NEA Baptist, Barton's Home Outlet, Jonesboro Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, Cavanaugh Auto Group, and First National Bank. This has been